Yeah.
Oh,
Okay.
man.
Have we all finished?
Good.
That was good.
I think we'll be finished as well.
Yes, we're all finished. Okay.
Ooh, I'm full.
Zellie.
Unlike my character.
You race
That's
around and
exactly
you
the same.
see. Yes, you've seen this orc at the foot of the stairs. Onto the second level of the keep. He has a short bow, he has it notched, and he's pointing at the stone banister alcoves, like the balconies, overlooking the ground floor. And he's shouting instructions to the other orc who's got the short sword and buckler. And he's shouting in orcish, more or less along the lines of, can you see him, can you see him? He's moving his gaze, his aim, from one balcony to the next balcony, then back again, like a sniper. And the other orc is slowly making his way along but the balcony railing. Lee, you've jumped into the room.
Yes.
It's incredibly dark here because there's only windows open on three of the four sides of the keep. So this area is considerably dark. You've got your torch, which is nothing more than a plank of wood with a whole load of rags tied on one end.
Yes.
Fully ablaze, and it is illuminating you, the floor around
and
you,
the, room.
The
yes.
walls, the corner you're hiding in, and the vast majority of the room.
I want to chuck the torch over here.
Okay. You throw the torch to one side.
Yep.
You throw the torch to one side. It lands on the floor. You don't have to do a roll or anything like that. You literally just say, right, I'll just throw it in that direction. You're not intending or trying to hit something. It's just landing on the floor.
Yes.
It's still illuminating the room. And it's illuminating that doorway. The orc hears that.
Yes.
And he starts moving his way round the door. Zellie.
I've got my sword drawn as well, just to make sure.
You draw your sword just ready.
Yeah.
Zellie, you're at the top of the stairs, and you see this orc archer just covering the doorway, because he heard the roll of wood as well hitting the floor. It echoed throughout this whole chamber.
I wait.
You gotta wait at the top of stairs.
Yeah.
Okay. Orc archer slowly sidestepping, still keeping his gaze on that door.
Crap.
Moving his way down to there. Oh, not there. There.
He's jumped over
he's
the
still
balcony.
Covering. He's still covering. The orc has now moved into the alcove, and he's trying to maneuver around the alcove to have a look in this room without actually going into the room.
Crap.
Lee.
Yes.
He can now he's got a line of sight on that burning torch now on the floor.
I stay as far into the corner as I can.
You're
against
right in the
wall.
You're right in the corner.
Yeah.
Up against this wall.
Yeah, up against this wall bit here, and then I just wait.
Okay, you're waiting. It's literally a waiting game now. Zellie.
Yeah.
How far is he now from me?
Let's say 30 feet.
Oh, I was hoping he'd stay there.
No, he's moved down. He's moved down. He's now covering this door, and he's now covering that door.
Because I'm scared he's going to look up this way.
No, he's doing. He's watching this way, and he's watching that way.
I'm going
to
crouch
there.
Against any kind of wall and
so he's,
slowly
he's
go down
left.
The stairs.
Yeah, he's aiming left.
So can I go like that? Can I go like that? But crouching.
He's sneaking. Okay. The orc archer, he has notched an arrow. He's using a short bow. He's snapping it to the left, like right away along the open balcony now. And you can see his orc friend just standing there waiting, trying to get a better view into the room. And then he's snapping it to his right, pointing at the staircase going down. So he's covering the actual balcony area, and he's covering
That's
the
fine.
Corridor area. Okay, Lee, you are in this corner, waiting, and orc with the short sword and the buckler is now ready just to come into the room. Okay, he's just in the doorway.
Okay, so from the point where I am, can I see him yet, or...?
You can see him as he comes through the door.
Yeah,
you're
well,
right
I think
this
as
corner.
Soon
you put yourself right in this corner, you're right up against this wall. You'd have to be parallel to him.
As soon as he comes through the door and I see him, I swing my sword down towards his face. I go forward and aim for his head.
Okay, Lee.
I'm gonna try to cut his head off.
Any initiatives?
initiative. You get a surprise. Do you want to use your ambush skill?
Do I have an ambush skill?
You do have an ambush.
Let me have a look at that.
I don't have ambush, you do.
It's minus 25. No, I don't.
It's minus 25.
Oh, it's minus 24, so
oh,
ambush.
Oh, my lord!
Okay.
I don't want ambush. I just want to use my one-handed edge.
Okay, you just want to take a swing at him,
yeah? It's not clever at ambush. Yeah, yeah. I'm just going to swing.
Oops, sorry.
Ready,
Oh, look, 94.
Yeah, it's right.
Six. Take it.
Take
it's a
it.
Six, and it's your roll.
Oh. Sorry.
Oh, that's a good one.
That's a nine.
Five.
It's a five. 95
one shot.
Plus
okay.
My 31.
Plus 31. Okay, let me just...
I must at least hit him. I want to cut his head right off. So his body just falls down.
You madman. Madman!
He's attacking back.
I mean, he's not attacking back yet. Depends what you did to him, but... He's got 111 on him.
It's probably that's got to be a good roll, I mean...
That's
a 95.
111, 17 points damage, and a C critical.
Cool.
And wow.
But yeah.
Wait, what did you roll?
Probably loads.
Oh, he takes an additional 10 hit points. He is bleeding. He's taken one hit per round. It unfortunately is a little too far over for his head. So what you do is the end of your sword rips through his shoulder and his upper arm, tearing the muscle. He drops his sword. He still has the booklet in his other arm, but he takes a massive amount of damage, and he's bleeding all over the floor.
Cool.
He's not dead, but he is bleeding, and he is screaming. This guy now is just, like, wondering whether to shoot at the door or just to run. Zellie, you hear an orc just scream from the doorway, and what sounds like a sword hit the floor.
I'm still sneaking up to this guy.
no reaction.
Okay. Because he's distracted and he's more concentrated on what's happening in this room, you can get within about 8 feet of him.
Can I reach him with 8 feet?
With what?
With a club?
No.
Or a short sword?
No.
Spell or not to spell? Because I can spell him now. I'm going to waste another spell slot. I can do 6 spells in total, but...
You can. A day. Remember, a day.
I'm going to YOLO spell on
spell
this preservation.
You're gonna...
Spam preservation!
Okay. Base spell. So, base spell.
I don't know, I forgot the base spell again.
Is it base spell 2?
It was plus 2. Yeah, I can see on my sheet.
Okay, 2 minus 35 for the orc, so you're down to minus 33 at the moment.
Am I?
Yeah, minus 33.
Shh, wow.
Okay.
That's crazy.
Minus 33 for the moment. Okay, you got a plus 20 bonus because he's not expecting you to be there, so that gives you minus 13. You need to roll something.
What?
Go.
That was a flick. That wasn't proper.
go. Run a guy over. It's a 5.
Whatever. Okay. Time to do snooker with this dice. Because that...
It's the only way that works for you.
Yeah.
Yo.
What did
that's
they do?
A 9. There you go.
91. Snooker.
I'm great at doing snooker, guys.
91 minus 13
with the dice.
Oh. Hey,
I'm great at doing snooker with
dice.
The dice.
Oh,
that's good.
I have to remember to do that because I get way too many low rolls for that to not happen.
Yeah, I used to do well with my rolls, and then I got your bad luck.
Yeah.
I think we need our own set of die. Maybe that. So it's unaffected by your rolls.
Stab me in the heart while I'm dying.
Or
okay.
Either mine doesn't affect yours or yours doesn't affect mine.
Where's the dice?
Either way. It's there. 91 plus whatever.
Okay, if he gets under 25, he drops down. If he gets over 25, the spell has no effect.
Really?
Yep.
Oh gosh, why?
This is his resist, is it?
No!
Oh, no!
Okay, yeah.
I wasted the spell!
He's resisted it. He doesn't feel the spell hit him. It just doesn't have any effect on him, so you haven't touched him because it was a ranged attack.
I've wasted the spell, basically.
Yeah, so 1 point off. He doesn't realize it, but he because it was an actual touching spell, and it wasn't a forceful one. It was like a passive spell. But yes, he's resisted that one.
Oh, Zellie, did you mark down you used the spell?
Yeah, I used the spell. It says
that's
full now.
That's just 1 point. She used 1 point. After all that, she just used 1 point.
Yeah.
Okay, Lee.
Yes?
This orc is screaming.
Is he attacking me?
Oh, the best part of the song!
Is he literally... Because he hasn't had a turn yet, he's literally just got his arm chopped off.
You haven't chopped his arm off. Your sword's just gone straight through his shoulder. He's torn all the muscle down from the shoulder to the elbow. He's dropped his sword. He is screaming. He has hit the floor.
He's taken a massive amount
of damage. He's bleeding. He's losing one hit point per turn, so he is bleeding.
Yeah, I'm gonna hit him again.
Okay, take a swing at him.
Hooah!
It's a prone position, so it's plus 25 for prone.
Okay. And I've got 9. And... Shit.
Why did you do that?
What did you do?
I hit the red dice, what was a 9. It went to a 1.
Oh, dude.
You idiot!
So you got 10.
No, I got 1.
Okay.
Yeah, 10.
What's your offensive bonus for sword?
Oh,
but
that is with my plus 31, one-hand edge.
Now that's not my fault. You rolled nicely and you ruined it for yourself.
Oh, I know.
Why did you?
My defense is... I didn't mean to hit it. My defense.
Throw it the opposite way then.
31 plus 31. That's 62.
Why you have really bad aim when you're trying to...
Yeah, you bring your sword down on his back. The armor takes most of the punishment, but you put another cut into him. But you haven't done anything in the way of critical damage.
You bloody idiot!
But yes, you just brought yourself, because he's literally laid there face down on the floor screaming, trying to roll around. Just literally slashing away at him, and he is has no way of defending himself. But yes, he you put another cut in him and do an extra 3 points of damage.
Okay.
He's dead yet?
Oh. He's not far off bleed to death.
Zellie. I can't believe I did that.
I
got 9.
You pretty much.
I got my club. I got my short. No, club or short sword.
Well, your club. I don't know what that does for damage, but remember your short sword does minus 5, so you only end up having 5 damage with it.
Yeah, it's because I have proficiency.
So your club then, you have none, do you? Or?
My club is concussion and I have plus 10.
You're probably still better off using the club, to be honest, then. At least you have 10 or 5.
I'll just use my club to whack him over the head.
Okay.
That's
fine. I'm gonna die!
Everybody in the house heard that one, but.
Oh my God. That's happening in my head. I'm going to die.
Come on.
Because this is my literally first battle ever.
Well, I think you're dead anyway, so don't worry.
Did you roll?
She hasn't rolled yet, no.
Oh, I haven't rolled yet!
Roll?
I was just staring at the orc going, I'm going to die! If I don't hit him properly over the head.
Seven.
I'm keeping that. Mm. I don't care. Whatever that is.
77.
Okay, I'm keeping that. Plus 10. 87.
Oh, 87. And this is one-handed concussion.
Yeah, one-handed concussion because it's a club. So it's plus 10.
87. You do 8 points of damage and a critical.
So does it hit his head?
You've hit. You've swung at where his head is. Oh, let me just check to see what a club does. A club.
I don't know what a club does.
It's a crush.
Maybe it would have been better to use your edge sword if you got that.
Okay, so you got an A, so you got minus 20 from this. So roll the dice, Sally.
Again?
Yeah, just tell me what it is. Yeah. Straight dice roll.
Oh, straight dice roll. Okay.
Straight dice roll, yeah. Go, just no modifiers, just roll the dice.
Okay.
Are you doing, you're doing the flick in it now.
Here we go. Da, da, da.
Ooh.
93.
72. So, you.
Oh, the first roll was to hit.
Yes, that's right. Yeah.
And the second roll's for damage. Okay.
Okay. What you've done is, by some miracle, by some strange coincidence, you bring your blow down on him just as he takes a step forward. You miss his head.
What?
Your club goes past his shoulder, past his back, but smashes into his leg.
I shattered his knee.
He's broken his leg bone.
He did manage to miss his head and go straight for his leg.
Yes.
She's 6 foot, she's gone from top to bottom.
You smashed into his leg, you've broken his leg, because he took a step forward just as you went to swing at him. He's minus 40 to all activity. He's in pain, clutching hold of his leg. He's dropped his bow. His arrow's just gone flying off into the darkness.
And oh, where did the arrows go?
12 points, so he's taken 10, 20 points damage, and he's at minus 40. Okay, he is screaming, getting
hit. Where did the arrows go?
The arrow just shot off into the darkness.
Oh, he shot an arrow into the
He just fired his arrow into the darkness. He had his his bow notched, and he was just stepping forward as if to say, what's going on in the darkness?
Yeah, yeah.
And just as he took a step forward, you went to swing at his head, totally missed his head, missed his shoulder, missed his back, and brought it down on his leg, on his rear leg. You've broken the rear leg bone.
Injured.
Okay.
Yes, he's taken...
So he's now in pain and he's going, ah!
Yes, yeah. he's gone down. He fired the bow, the arrow just went off. You don't know where the arrow went off, he just shot off somewhere. Somewhere insignificant, just into the blackness. He's dropped his bow is on the floor. He's got both hands on his leg now, and he is screaming in some kind of high-pitched lizard tongue. Rolling around, he's rolled onto his back, and he is holding his leg very, very tightly. But he can't do anything. He can't get up, and he can't he can't maneuver. And if he does try to maneuver or try to do anything, he's at a minus 40 penalty for everything that he does, just for sheer pain.
Ah, cool.
I crouch back down again, though. After that, I was like, "But please." Just in case.
Okay.
Slightly.
Lee.
Oh, dear. Yes.
This orc is now silent.
This one, is he dead?
Yeah, he's on the floor, he's out.
Yeah.
Okay.
I presume I've heard that guy shout.
You heard another orc somewhere, from outside of the room, screaming. You don't know why he's screaming, but he is shrieking.
Okay, I come around the corner, just poking my head around the corner.
Okay.
So I can see everything. Wrong way.
Yeah?
Just so I can see.
You stick your head around the corner. This kind of corridor, open balcony and corridor area is fairly lit.
Yeah. Zellie's
and
crouched,
you
so
see
I can't
Zellie
see
is crouched down behind the actual stone guardrail. But there is an orc, half out, half in, lying on his back, screaming for some reason.
Okay. I want to walk over there.
Okay.
With my sword out.
Yeah.
And slash at him. Like, I want to bring it down into his head. Or throat. Or
chop
chest
his
or
head off.
I don't really care. I just want to.
Okay, roll.
I want to make him silent.
Roll.
Roll.
Roll, roll,
roll. Boy, roll. Now you need to flick at it. There you go.
54.
54, which OB? 31, will
OB is 31, yeah.
Okay, that's 81. He doesn't get defensive bonus. Is it minus 40? So 40 on top of that. 100 and...
I want to do a strike down to him.
Yeah, that's a 20 hit points damage, so you've done enough damage to actually kill him, but we'll see what the critical is. Roll both dice, roll the dice again. Add 10.
Cool. So it doesn't really matter what I get, I've killed
it
him.
It doesn't really matter, yeah, because... You...
Wow, 83.
Now you roll good!
That's 93.
When it doesn't matter, you roll good.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter.
When
well, that's
doesn't...
the thing. You know, when I'm not in battle, I can roll for good drink.
I guess we have to keep thinking,
okay,
don't care in the world.
Okay, you strike down on the side of his head. It cuts deep into the side of his head. Knocked out, well, he's knocked, he says knocked out for 6 hours, but he's actually dead now, so additional 10 hit points. If no helmet, he dies instantly, so he's dead.
Yeah, he dead. Be gone, dead dwarf. Not dwarf.
Dwarf?
He's not dwarf, he's an orc, man.
I know, I meant that.
Where are we going to put the dead orcs?
No, no, you can stay there for now, funny, because...
Yeah, because I need to get his bow.
Yeah, let's just give him
a
thing
got
now.
A bow. Okay, he's got a short bow there, which is still in one piece. It's an orc and show bow.
Does he have any
short...
arrows on him?
Yes, he has a quiver of about 8.
I'm going to take that quiver.
Short arrows. They're all at minus...
I'm going to put a quiver on me!
They're all
as
very,
still does
very
that,
badly made, and they're all at minus 5.
Oh, hi!
Yeah,
what?
Estel just goes looking through the orc's body. I go, oh, you are alive then. Thanks for letting me know about this.
Yeah, the short bow's at minus 5, Zellie.
Oh,
it's a very badly made shock, orc bow.
It doesn't matter because I have plus 20.
What, in range attack?
Missile.
Missile, whatever, that's range attacking it.
Yeah, missile.
Yeah, missile. And I can put on...
Okay, so you have one...
It, would it go
bow.
In items, or what, my quiver?
You can put in items. 8 arrows.
It'd be an item,
eight
would it
arrows,
not be
yeah.
a weapon item?
Yeah, but...
So...
It's a minus 5
eight
bow.
8 arrows.
Yeah, 8 arrows for a short bow, and the bow is minus 5 because it is an orc item, and it is very poorly maintained and made.
What's the range on the short bow?
Short bow is about 90 feet.
Okay. Better than my spells.
Yeah.
Yay! I was waiting for a short bow for so long. I don't care if it's craply made.
Okay, there is...
I'll go see what's on the other orc over here. So I'll have a little search to see what he had.
He had a short sword and a buckler.
What's a buckler?
A buckler is a small shield that you hold with your fist. It's like it's a bit like a tin pot lid.
Oh, okay.
You use it for...
He's got nothing else on him, has he? No cash.
The orcs don't tend to have cash.
No trinkets.
No trinkets.
Can I do a real good search for him for trinkets?
You can do a real good search if you really want. Wait, if you want to do a real good search, you'll find that he has a necklace of mouse skulls.
I'm good.
don't want the necklace of mouse skulls, no?
No, I'm good.
Okay. Just warning you, there is an unconscious orc upstairs, but he's going to bleed to death in about 50 minutes. Oh, 55 minutes.
Yeah.
However long he was unconscious.
He's going to be dead, yeah. As soon as he wakes up or the spell breaks, he's going to be dead, so...
Right, I want to know what's upstairs now, because she's been so long.
Because I just said that, right?
Zellie can explain what's upstairs.
Yeah.
You're telling me
as I'm walking past. So you've said all that. And I ask if there's anything good out there, then.
Not that I saw.
Okay.
It's
so you didn't find
empty.
Anything up there.
Actually, I want to finish looking at those books that I never got to finish, because you yelled! You yelled!
Well, your dinner's ready down there. You know, get food.
I should have just said, don't yell, because we still don't know if it's completely empty or not. I should have just said that to you. I am an idiot for thinking that you're not an idiot. So... There we go.
Oh, whatever. I'm storming off now.
Where?
Down. I'm going back.
Well, at least we're alive. Whatever.
I came down to help her and she's been really mean. Just
no!
That's
aww.
Is my torch still glowing, Barbie?
Down here, yes. It's still going.
Can I pick it up?
Yes, you can pick it up.
I go down and I come back up saying it's dark.
Oh, wait. My torch.
I've got my torch back.
Okay, right. You go down the stairs, you realise it's pitch black, you come back and say, I forgot my torch. Pick me torch, pick your torch up, and then head back downstairs and head out into the...
Oh, come on.
...preparation area. Zellie, what are you doing?
He just I was going to say, I go quickly back up, make sure I didn't miss any books that I didn't look at, because books...
Okay, you make your way back to the book area.
I never wrote that down, did I? I took a book.
You did. You took a book from here. It was the
elf history.
The history of the elves. And it was history of the elves and the long night, the longest night.
Elf. I just put elf history book.
Yeah. And then there was the pile of books in this room. As well, there was a pile of books and there were some books on the shelves. And don't forget that piece of paper that you found in your...
Yeah, I wrote the one poem.
Yeah, you wrote the poem. Lee, you're back outside.
Yeah, I thought, screw that, you know, she's... I asked her a simply question, you know, if there was anything good up there.
I said that there wasn't.
And then she went and had a little moan at me saying that I'm stupid and I shouldn't have shouted. It's like, how the hell was I meant to know? So I'm off a little hump, I'm going to explore the broken down towers.
Which one?
I'll go into this one first because I presume it's the only one I can get into, and it looks like there's a connecting wall, so I presume I can walk along it. Or
yes. You can get to all the towers, Tower 2 and Tower 4. They are like run down and collapsed. Tower 3 and Tower 1 are still intact.
Okay, so yeah, I want to have a look getting into Tower. Well, which was this? 2. I'll go to Tower 2 first. Have a look in there.
Okay, you head towards Tower 2, Zellie. You are searching through the books.
Yeah.
To the right dealer or the right collector, if you can find a collector, there's around about 50 books.
Oh man, I can't carry 50 books.
If you could find a way to carry 50 books, you will be able to sell them for about 100 gold pieces.
Oh my word! I'll just get the really intact books.
They're all based on astrology. They're all based on astronomy and stuff like that. And about the planets and the stars and the constellations and all the kind of stuff. To a good astrologer, you'd probably pay about 100 gold pieces. These are fairly old books, probably about 500 years old.
I'll take the one that's least, that's most preserved.
Most preserved.
The one that doesn't have falling out pages.
Okay.
And that has a decent cover. Okay, is not damp.
Have a quick look and just
anything.
Think. Yeah, the ones at the top of the pile are more dry than the ones at the base of the pile.
I'll take one of each pile. The top ones that are dry.
You grab a couple of books from the top of each pile. Again, they're about the stars and constellations and about astrology, astronomy and all kinds of stuff, the planets, planetary rotation, the phases of the moon, eclipses, all that kind of stuff. There's 3 books in total, which you assume as being actually like worth taking. If you can find somewhere to sell them, you will be able to sell them for around about 5 gold pieces.
Into my backpack. 3 astrology books.
3 astrology books, yes.
And in this one?
In this one you find 2 books.
In here?
Where you at?
Which one are you saying there's 2 books?
There was a pile here.
Where are you drawing? Oh, there you go.
Yes. Oh. There was a pile there, yes. Mm-hmm. In that pile, you take the top 3 books, which are the 3 books I said. If you manage to find somewhere where you can sell them, a good astrologer would pay...
Oh, that's the ones you were talking about.
Somewhere in the region of around about 5 gold pieces.
Okay, that's the one you were talking about.
Okay, yeah, the place where you picked up the poem.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Yeah?
Because my counter was in here, so I thought it was one of these, but...
No, you,
sorry.
You picked up a book from here, which was the elf, the history of the elf.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
So, yes. Alright?
Yeah. So, I'm guessing that's nothing else.
Nothing else, no. Unless you can find somewhere to ship Around about 100 bucks.
I just want to do like I did in the room in the inn and perceive the room, if I haven't done that already.
You want to perceive which room?
I probably have done it already.
This room?
Before. Yeah.
Okay, yeah, you can roll.
Really perceive it, like, look. And
take your time
it.
Looking for it, okay.
Because the orcs are dead, I don't have anything to worry now. Okay.
What'd you get?
42 plus whatever. 17.
42 plus 17. Nope, you can't find anything else of any value in this room apart from the big pile of books that's in front of you, which if you can find somewhere to be able to get it to an astrologer, you might be able to sell for about 100 gold.
Yeah, but considering I don't want to carry too many books.
No, there's about 200 books there.
Yeah, exactly.
Books, that's heavy.
Is there any books on the map of the area?
No.
I want to sift through the books.
You spend your time sifting through the books. Lee?
Yes, I'm exploring.
You are exploring Tower 2.
Yeah. So, like, what do I see when I enter the room?
You enter Tower 2. Tower 2 is literally a crumbling mess. There's obviously the big pile of... There's no roof to it. There's the big pile of rubble. There's lots of brambles and a lot of nettles and things like that. There's lots of twisted pieces of metal, some support beams of wood. And there is some bones, a skeleton, with an arrow through the ribcage. And there's an awful smell of dead flesh.
I want to go towards the skeleton then and just have a look, see if there's anything around there.
There's nothing on the skeleton. It looks like it was like a couple of hundred years ago. Yeah, 400 years ago. You can tell he died by an arrow.
Yes, there's a big arrow
sticking out of his ribcage, but it's like a ballista bolt arrow rather than an actual conventional arrow, so it must have been from a siege weapon.
Oh, okay, so it was
a siege weapon of some sort. Many of his bones have been crushed, and it had probably been somebody defending the fort when it was attacked in the past. That's what you can deduce from that. There's nothing else to look around to see.
I want to start heading to the next tower then.
Okay, you head over to the next tower. What's the next tower?
Number three. How do I get to number three? Do I go along this bit of the wall?
Yes, you can go along the wall. It's fine.
Okay, let's do that.
You put your in number three. I'll find out where number three is at. Number three. Zellie, you're still searching through the books?
I'm making another pile of the books I've seen and just looking at the tile, see if they're... Yeah.
Okay, tile three.
Because I don't want to make a mess.
You just let a load of blood spew out in an hour's time.
Yeah.
Where's the dice gone?
One of them's there.
Oh, the top there.
I'll roll it. Ready?
Oof. What's that for?
Nine.
Okay, Lee... You,
yes.
As you approach the tower, you hear something snoring.
Oh, okay.
He sulks off, and then he's going to get himself in more trouble.
It's your fault.
There's something there that is snoring. You can stick your head in and have a look.
Tower is this? Tower 3?
This is Tower 3.
Is there
this
like
one?
A hole or anything I can... Look under or through the hole.
No, you can just stick your head in and have a look. You see nine orcs.
Nine.
Sleeping.
Right, okay.
We just killed its mates. We killed three of their guys.
Oh, crap, nine. That's a lot of guys. Shit. Holy shit, what have I got? I've got like a Molotov.
Make sure for Molotov.
Shit, if I only had that. If I only had my alcohol.
Oh yeah, I still have your alcohol.
Yeah.
You can make a Molotov out of that.
I can't anymore, I ain't got it.
There is nine...
Get an old rag from
There's
one of
nine
the
orcs.
Rooms.
I'll tell you what else is in the room, apart from the nine orcs, just to give you some idea of what's in there. There is one, two, three, four beds. There is a small small dressing table, like desk.
Oh, that's... I was looking at the wrong tower. That's tower three. Oops.
Yeah, dressing table, and there is a small chest.
Oh, right, that okay. chest. You're not a good Lucky. Sneaker.
I'm not good at anything at the moment.
Except riding.
Okay, but yes, you can hear them snoring. They are snoring and stirring. But you don't know why they're sleeping in there. Maybe because it's daytime.
Oh, God, I'm really torn between sneaking in and killing them one by one. And
but one of them is going to definitely scream.
There's nine of them.
Yeah.
You're going to have eight orcs on your butt. If you kill one.
Okay. I'm going to shut the door closed, like, quietly. And
okay, leave. You come straight out. You come back out of the Zellie.
On the run.
Have I finished?
Yes, you've searched. You can't find anything else apart from this dirty, gripping, huge pile of books, which you know fine well. If you took it back to Tharbad, you could easily make 100 gold out of it.
Well, I can't carry any of them anyway.
No.
Maybe once we get Lee's cart back.
Leo's cart, yeah, maybe.
Oh, I have a use for your cart then. since I'm pretty sure we've
You wait
done...
until the information I have to tell you in a minute. Whew. Back here.
Shh, oh, you're not with me. since I've probably done with the books, I'm guessing done with the books here as
you
well.
Look in the library, that's the laboratory, that's the library, and like joining those two rooms together is the assistance room.
So I've done them.
Then there's
I've
the observatory. Yeah, there's observatory, and then there's the actual the chamber. Yeah. So this is like.
So I've done this. I've done this.
This is the whole bedroom suite, kind of, and the laboratory and the study area for the astrologer who used to live in this castle.
Yeah, due to the telescope.
Due to the telescope, yes. The telescope used to point up through the hole in the roof, but the orcs have put it to another use. They use it as a recreational tool as well as like an observation tool. So this upstairs chamber is for an astrologer. It's an astrologer's tower, like an observatory. You know those things that you see out on the moors?
Mm-hmm.
Pretty much that's what this thing is, this entire keep is. Lee is... But it has fallen into rack and ruin, and it looks like some of the orcs have come down from the Misty Mountains in the last dozen or so years, and have been using it as kind of like a hideout place, and you have stumbled into it. There's still a lot of things in this place, but a lot of it... The orcs aren't very much interested in astrology. They like the telescope. The telescope's like a nice toy.
Yeah. I'm going to go out like that, so I can just watch the orc body.
Okay, yes.
And I go, he's still unconscious, I'm guessing.
He's still out of it, yes.
How long has it been since I made him unconscious?
It has quite been an hour.
I didn't think it was an hour yet. I just wondered if it was 10 minutes or 20 minutes now.
No, it's been about 20 minutes or so, but it's been nowhere near an hour. It's usually about 20 to 30 minutes.
What? I've cooked sausages in that time, though.
Yes, you cook sausages.
I go through like that, and then... Because I'm making sure I did impale him properly.
Oh, yes, you just give him... you definitely make sure he's dead, yes. Or when he's dead, when he does come
give
up.
Give him another poke.
A poke in the head.
God.
In his brain and his heart. Oh my gosh. Although that was gross.
You don't really delight in poking dead orcs.
I wasn't delighted in poking it.
You see, you don't take much delight in poking dead. You don't take much delight in actually getting next to an orc.
But considering we just had that little fight, I don't want to fight them anymore, so I'm pretty glad. So I go down the stairs.
You're down the stairs. You're now on... You're working your way through the actual landing.
To here.
Your way down to there. Yes. Lee?
I guess Lee. My gosh.
I'm making my way towards where Estelle is. Estelle?
You decided, it might be a good idea to stick together. Not to go exploring strange new places all by yourself.
He sulked off, and then he saw the problem, and then he's like, yeah, I'm going to go back to Estelle. He's like...
two weapons are better than one against nine.
Still, nine is a horrible number.
But we can stealth two at the same time. And then it brings you down to seven.
But it's seven against two. It's even worse.
You took two out. I've done one. It's fine.
But that was three against two, and that was great. Actually, it was two against two because I'll wait until you come to me because I can at least say that.
Yeah, because you can sit and you can argue it out.
Because I was gonna say.
Back into the keep, Zellie. You are at the top of the stairs of the first, the second floor.
Yeah, I'm continuing my way down.
Are you coming straight down?
Yeah, because I've looked through all here, so I don't need to.
You meet Lee, who's coming back into the building for some reason you're not sure about, on the ground floor.
I say, we need to leave now. There's nine orcs sleeping in that tower.
Which tower?
And I point.
Point?
This one.
That one. Number three.
Number three, tower three.
Oh, I was hoping there was just three. Oh.
Come on, quick. Let's go.
But, wait. But, we haven't... Yeah, I'm spacing out like crazy. I guess put out the fire at least.
This is the situation you have. You have explored the keep. You have found a few bits and pieces, and you found some clues that lead to another location. Or Zellie has found some clues that lead to another location. Lee has searched Tower 2, which is in Rack and Ruin, and has the remains of a person, Defender, who was killed by a ballistic bolt from a siege engine some hundreds of years in the past. And he's explored Tower 3. Tower 3 is intact. Tower 1 is intact. Tower 3 has nine sleeping orcs in it, as well as some furnishings. Tower 4 is in rubbles. Tower 1 is intact. So that's the situation you're facing at the moment.
Well... If you're worried about making noise, just...
Nine orcs. Nine.
Well, don't go in the tower, then.
Are you some sort of orc friend here or something? I absolutely hate orcs. Do you understand there's nine of them and they will just swarm us?
That's why I don't go in. I didn't say, like, oh, let's just go ballistic and kill my orcs. We just had, like...
We're going to look around a bit more, shall we? And we'll just wait for one of them to wake up and come get their friends.
We're
going to
do this pretty quickly. Actually, what happened to the fire anyway?
The fire's still going.
No, it's died down, is it? It's just embers.
It's died down now. It's just hot embers and charcoal and ash, yes.
Your sausages are over there as well. You never ate.
I'm sorry. It's just that, as you saw, there was quite a lot of floors. And the top floor had a lot of books, although there were those orcs, and I didn't realize you were going to yell down and then all the thing. But I guess in the end it did help, because they left the room and I could make one of them unconscious. So it would play
the others didn't hear me when I yelled.
Yeah, thank goodness the nine didn't hear you. Otherwise, we would have been swarmed.
That's not to say they won't wake up any minute now.
Anyway, let's just at least quickly...
It's a good job that we're asleep.
Yeah, because I did
What is it that you found then? You find anything good?
That was...
Before you called me stupid again.
There was one scroll that turned into dust, but the other one had, like... There was another one that said about an entrance in the stable outside somewhere. I thought I at least looked for that.
Entrance to what?
I don't know.
So after saying there's nine orcs in the tower sleeping, you still want to look? Don't know how many more orcs there could be?
Oh, don't make too much noise and it'll be fine. As you see, I did fine until you yelled, so, you know, just do that.
I sort of turn around and just walk away.
I'm complimenting you. You made a noise and then it helped me knock one of them out and level the playing field in terms of them. Luckily, the other orcs didn't wake up. They were sleeping.
The three that were alerted to your screaming and shouting were already awake.
Yes. And they could already see us by what you...
You didn't check the Tower 1 and Tower 4 yet, have you? That side?
Those ones that you're pointing at. No, I haven't. But it's because there's orcs in that one there.
Well, yeah, I'll just go here. Where's the sausage? What's the sausage image?
It's probably a really cold lump thing there.
I don't care. I'm going to just take it. I'm hungry. I've been through so much already.
So that's 1.5 sausages you've eaten.
1.5 sausages?
Yeah.
Did you bite into that other sausage?
Yeah. So you can choose to eat the half or not.
God.
You can keep that half.
Fine, I'll eat that. How good are you with a sword? How good are you with a sword? If you want to stay longer, you better be good. You cleared up my marks that I made on my rubble.
Yeah.
Well, you see what I did? I clubbed a guy.
Okay, so this one is in rubbles. This one has orcs. This one is in rubbles.
I want to go in this one.
You're going to go in that one.
God, okay. So what? You're
going
to poke
my head through in that one.
I stay with her.
With the after eating that one sausage, yeah, and then I want to look.
I do a little burp.
Okay, this room is flooded.
Number one, is it?
Yep, tower one. It's flooded. There's a staircase going down into the water. There is a very corroded gold-coloured chest resting on the ledge 10 feet below the waterline. So at the bottom of the...
This one?
Of the water. Tower one.
That one?
Oh, wow. 10 feet below.
Yeah. Where are you? Both kinds of side, yeah?
Over here on the left-hand side of the map.
So I was just checking here. This one? Yeah. Is this the chest?
So
yeah, there's a chest. There's a 10 feet under the water. There is a corroded gold chest. A very small one. Corroded gold chest. This water is black.
When you say small, do you mean small as in edible to pick up?
That music box.
A little music, yeah, okay.
Music box. Music box size. I'm not saying it's a music box, but it's music box sized. Small little... corroded, very corroded, like it's got silt and mud and all that kind of stuff, but it is golden. Small little golden chest.
Is it black, dirty water, or is it just...
Well, we must be able to see the chest.
You can see the chest? It's 10 feet below the surface of the water, 10 feet.
So 10 feet's pretty... It's still pretty clear, then, if we can still see it.
Then we should be able to reach in, right?
You can't reach 10 foot.
Kind of.
Well, I suppose you could if you're 6 foot. You go in a little bit.
I won't be completely...
You would have to physically go in the water to reach 10 foot.
Yeah. I don't know if I want to swim in that, though.
If you're 6 foot high,
yeah,
your character's 6 foot.
I only need to extend myself 4 more feet.
Single round stone.
But you would have to go under 4 feet.
It's intact.
Yes, I'll submerge myself.
As you go through the doorway, you see that it is like it goes down about 4 or 5 feet. And then it's just water. There's steps going down into the water, and you can see 10 feet into the water. So you don't know how deep it is, but it must be at least 10 feet deep. You can see a small, badly corroded, dirty gold chest on a ledge 10 feet down.
I'm worried about
in
this water.
The water. But the water is still.
I turn to Estelle. And I say, well, maybe it was a good idea you wanted to check out these towers, and there's quite a nice shiny box down there.
Yeah, I'm seeing it too.
Off you go. Can you swim? I ask her. You can swim, right, can't you?
Not amazingly.
I can tread water-ish.
Wait, what's your skills? I want to know. Wait.
I'm gonna... a plus 6 on mine.
Oh, you're worse than me.
Yeah, I know.
Oh. I kind of don't want to dip myself in there. It looks dirty.
Okay, you
it
keep an
really
eye open.
It looks really dirty.
You keep an eye open. I will go in.
But if you really feel like you're not the better swimmer, then...
Well, I hope I don't... I'm not going to drown, because I can tread
each
water.
Each one of you roll the dice.
Is this where we both go both fall in?
No, just each one.
Oh, we both?
Yeah, one person rolls a dice, next person rolls a dice.
Both of them, yeah.
Still. Yeah, both of them.
Yeah. Oh, time for flicking.
Time for flicking.
You know it. You know it.
She got a two, so she has to.
Because I don't know what this is for.
Ooh. Oh.
What did I do?
81.
81. Okay, I'll flick.
Oh! Oh!
Where'd that go? Terrible.
Six.
Okay.
And I'll throw. Keep that six. I don't want to risk it. 60.
60.
Okay, you know that there is fish in the water.
Ah, okay. So we understand that it's linked up to the river outside. Which makes sense, because that's where the water would have come from then.
I'd imagine probably this water here.
So wouldn't it be this bit here, would it, then? Ah, okay. You wouldn't have been through, haven't you?
That's why it's dirty. Because this river was clean.
That river was clean, it was fairly shallow, but this is like deep, deep water, and there's a stream coming out. It says it was coming out from under the keep.
So there must be a hole
in
there.
Is it moggy water, or is it dirty water?
Dark water.
Okay, so like stopping a stir at the bottom.
Is it the better part of the tower roof?
Yeah.
It's in the water.
Oh, wait, do you want me to hold your makeshift torch?
Oh, I left it out by the fire ages ago.
Oh, never mind then. I didn't know you threw it there.
Yeah, so I did that in a tamp tune.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I offered to go in to pick it up.
Okay.
I was waiting for Estelle to say, no, I'll go. No, but I slowly make my way down. How far can I see the stairs are? I want to go
stairs
down.
Go
like,
down about 3 feet. The stairs go down about 3 feet, okay. And then they just stop. After that, it's just like a.
It's just because like it's dark. I don't know if it's because of the lighting in the room.
It's a sealed tower, apart from two turrets, which are further up above your head.
I guess it's because of the tower's dark.
I'm swimming.
Oh, then it's probably not that dirty.
Like, are you diving? You diving down to the chest? Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Roll the dice. Add your swimming.
Okay, so swimming is 6.
Oh, God. 100!
That's not 100, no, he hasn't rolled that
that's
yet.
A zero. I haven't
rolled that. Yeah, that's 100.
No,
he
I
hasn't
rolled,
rolled
the
it
blue.
Yet.
Oh.
I haven't rolled the blue.
Oh. Oh, no.
That's fine, because it means I can roll the blue into it.
Do it. Oh, are you on, doing ruler?
The ruler.
Ruler's not a flicking tool.
It's for measuring. Go.
Yes, I used it in school for flicking. Oh my god, that was crap.
Oh no!
I forgot I can't swim.
11 plus
6.
Oh no.
Okay, Lee, you literally dive your head under the water. Yeah?
Yeah.
You have difficulty trying to keep your eyes open under the water. You just sticking your hands out, trying to grab hold of where you think the chest is, but you can't get hold of the chest. You come back to the surface.
Oh, I want to try again.
Wait, how?
Zellie, you see Lee go under the water, splash around, and then just come straight back to the surface again.
Oh my goodness. When you said you weren't as good as swimming.
I got something in my eye, alright?
Okay.
I can't see where it is.
Fine, I'll dip. I'll soak this dress. Whatever. I'm going to tie it round like, so it's easy to swim. Yeah, and then
I'll
gonna
start climbing out then.
Huh?
I'll start climbing myself out then, should I?
We'll both get a bath, it's fine. I'm going to swim in.
Okay, Zellie goes to put herself in the water.
Suck ballsies! If I don't do this right. Okay. I don't know why Lee's hand is there. He's like...
Oh, 'cause I'm keeping an eye on the number.
97, roll again.
Oh, wow.
Damn.
Yeah. Since it's just like a dice 7, I'm going to roll them together because I don't care.
And 44.
She's a bit
plus monster. 17.
17, much better than me. So, I don't like doing the water stuff.
I guess I have to be the one to swim in things. Yay! Yay!
She does this amazing ballerina jump into the water.
I do a swan dive. It's such elegance and you're amazed.
Okay, Zellie.
Okay, what do I do?
You swim down. You can see the chest. You get your hands on the chest and your immediate reaction is to try and pick up the chest. You cannot move the chest. The chest is stuck to the ledge. It's not loose. It's deliberately built into the ledge.
Oh.
You quickly realize this, so you just lift the lid up, put your hand inside, and grab hold of 29 silver.
Ooh.
And then come straight back to the surface.
Let me put 29... I guess finders keepers.
It's just a handful of silver coins. You grab a handful of silver coins and...
Is there more coins in it? Can I go in there again? Dip myself again? For another go? To double check I got everything?
If you want to.
Because you said I grabbed a handful of coins. I'm going to grab another handful. Fudge it.
While she's doing that, then I'm checking to make sure that there's nothing coming down.
And drying yourself off, that's for sure.
Okay. Roll dice.
I'm guessing I'm rolling the dice again.
But if you want to go down again, yeah.
Yeah. I'm going to go down again. I got 29 silver. That's the... I'm keeping that. Fudge it. 79.
So 2 gold, 9 silver you got.
Okay, that's 29 silver. Was there anything more? I hope.
Yeah, he's rolling.
He's rolling for something.
Another 21 silver.
Another 21 silver?
No, sorry, 11, another 12. Another 12 silver.
Oh.
Another
so
12 that's silver.
31, 41. 41. I'm making money. When I picked it the first time and the second time, do I feel like there's still more in there?
You feel as if there's more in there.
I think I'm gonna do for one more dip and then I'm done with it. One more dip. One more. Three times the charm. One more. I'm gonna do.
Yeah.
One more.
Third times the charm. You go down with all the money still in your pocket and drop it all.
Oh shh.
Oh no!
No, I can still rectify this.
Oh, it would be so funny if it was 0-0. Oh no, 0-1. Oh, see, why doesn't it work like that for me?
67 plus whatever my swim is. 17. Oops. So I'm gradually getting lower rolls. For my swimming. Which makes sense! Eight silver. 49 silver.
Wow, 49 silver.
How many times have you tried? You tried four times now.
Three times. I've done it three times.
Okay. As you come to the surface, something black move in the water.
I come out anyway, because I said I would do it three times, and that's it. I'm out of the water. Fudge it. I don't even care if I see something. I'm out of the water.
Yeah, you see something. If you stick around longer, you'll have seen something that resembles like a very small kraken coming up from the water.
See?
So you were lucky there. Oh.
See? And I was thinking, I'm just going to dip in three times, and that's it. I'm so thankful that I did.
Very small kraken. It's like a baby octopus kind of thing. Moving around. And you can see the tentacles now just sweeping across the gold chest.
Did I close the chest when I left?
Yes, it closes itself.
Okay. I'm rich. by my standards.
Okay, Lee.
For how I started this out.
By my standards, you're
Zellie just dove into this pool of water trying to find out what this chest is. She couldn't lift the chest out because it was actually fixed to a shelf in the water, which is now an octopus has just decided to slither all over.
Yeah.
Thank goodness. I'm glad I just thought three times. See, I'm not too greedy. I'm greedy enough.
You managed to get yourself a good quantity of silver out of it.
Find his keepers.
Yeah. I say, what, you done treasure hunting now then?
Oh yeah, I'm done. Now we can look in that stable that I wanted to know about. And then we can leave. And then we can leave. So we're like here somewhere.
Okay.
Now we can leave.
You're heading over to the stable?
Yep.
I ask her what she found in the... I want to ask her what she found in the box as well.
Well, keep the voice down as well in case it does echo a lot. I just want to know what this... Because it could be that there's a dungeon underneath or maybe even more chests that I can... You know, we can loot out of, but and then we can leave quickly. But other than that,
just got to drop out of the game.
Okay.
Oh, okay. Da, 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 da. But yeah.
So yes, there's nine orcs sleeping in Tower 3. There is an octopus guarding a chest, which you cannot lift out. But it's just stuck in the water in Tower 1. Tower 2 is part of a rubble, and Tower 4 is part of a collapsed rubble as well.
Which I assume I can't get into from this side.
No, can't. You can't get into it. It's just it's literally caved in on itself, rubble, pile of rubble. Tower 4, yeah.
So I wanna check. I'm assuming... What? What happened there? Oh.
Lee's restarting there.
It just... Oh. Okay, that's how it does it. Okay. I got freaked out for a sec.
Lee came back in.
So, what's this? What was this?
As we were walking across there, though, I wanted to ask her what she got in a box.
Oh,
yeah, 9 orcs in there. There's a giant octopus kind of thing that lives in the bottom of that one.
What did you want to ask again? What?
I want to ask what you got in your little treasure excursion.
Firstly, how much did you lose money last time? How much did you spend in total?
In what?
In money.
On what?
In money.
On what? Where? On what?
When we started on this adventure.
Oh, so you were asking me generally, not my character. Sorry.
I want to remember how much you spent.
Enough. I spent enough.
I hand him...
If you really want to pay me back, remember, I did pay for you on the barge.
Oh, yeah. I give him 9 silver.
9 silver. Okay.
I give her 8 silver back, so she only cost 1 silver.
Oh, God.
No, you can... I've found a decent amount. I'm giving you 9 silver. At least.
I'm not a charity case. So... I earn my money.
Okay, you can have... Okay, it's 48 silver then. It's an even number. It's so nice.
Yes, I'll just take 1 from you.
Because I assume you didn't know how much I took out.
No, you just went down and kept coming back up. And I was just waiting by the door.
Lee was expecting you'd actually bring the chest up.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it's stuck on the thing.
Oh, I understand that now. You told me.
So it's like impossible to take out, so I could only grabbed what's inside and left.
No, that's fine. It's fine, as I say. It did pay out to do a little bit more search and then run away, but we've got to be cautious.
Well, yeah. I would stay in longer. I did plan in my head enough that I'll only dip 3 times since I only was able to grab little handfuls. And thankfully I did, because there was a little thing in the water that I don't want to
You're stood in this car.
I saw the measurement.
Talking,
no.
Yeah, and the ox are just like, yeah.
Well, I did say not to say too loud. We're just talking, Emma.
Yeah, we're not shouting. I'm aware.
I just want to double check. What was this?
What was what?
I just wanted to double check. What was this thing here?
That was like a barn thing, like a storage shed.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, that...
Oh, sorry.
That's a storage shed, which is now collapsed. That's a storage shed. This is a storage shed. And this is what
this
is left
of
the
stables.
And it's split into 6 stalls, kind of thing.
Because I want to go into the stable, because it said something about a stable.
Right.
And an entrance in the stable. It said on the scroll. I didn't take it with me, did I?
Did it actually mean this stable?
Did I take it with me?
You didn't take the stable. We didn't take the scroll with you. You just read it.
Yeah, because it's dusty and stuff, isn't it?
And it specifies.
It's annoying because there was nothing with maps. I was hoping for a map.
Map.
No maps. Map. I want a map. I want my character to know where we are. I go in the stable and
the stable.
I look into each one to see if there's an opening in there.
Okay, you go into each stable.
I'm guessing perception.
Yeah, it doesn't take you long to start. Like Lee walks over, like walking around on the stable, and as soon as he brings his boot down on something, you hear this dunk.
Yeah, like a wooden panel.
You already put out the fire, right?
Well, it's end.
It's like just burning embers.
Because then I can just end that fire noise.
Oh yeah, you can end the fire noise. I ended mine ages ago.
God.
Well, right. That's because you paused it, didn't you, for lunch break?
Yes.
Yeah.
Right. So you explore the stables, because Zellie found a scroll saying that there was some kind of hidden entrance in the stable block underneath one of the stalls. You're going round. Lee stands on. As soon as he brings, he's walking around with his boots. It's +10. Finely leather.
Yeah.
Very well made boots.
These boots are
he stands
made
on
walking.
Something and he hears this clunk and then a creaky sound, like as if it's a like it's not the firm earth underneath his feet.
Ooh.
You both get down on hands and knees and start scraping away the straw, and you find a wooden hatch.
Can I open it?
Yes, you pull it open. It's got like a rope on like a rope handle on one end of it. You lift it up and there is a ladder going down into the earth.
Oh, how dark is it? Is it pretty dark down there?
It's pretty dark.
I turn to it still. Can you see anything down there?
I look in.
You look in, you can see a ladder going down, and it goes down to a small landing, and then from that landing there's a staircase.
I will go in first then. Ladies first and all that.
Whatever.
Since I can see in the dark more than this guy.
This guy.
I guess I should follow.
Theo man.
Hey?
I'll just check.
I'll wait up here until you give me a signal okay or something.
I'll just get to the bottom and see what's there. I'll just get the bottom to these stairs. Ladder.
Ladder.
The ladder. When I get to the bottom of the ladder. I crawl down the ladder.
Okay. You get to the bottom of the ladder. It's only about 10, 12 runs down. And then you find yourself in what is something that resembles a mineshaft tunnel.
Okay.
With a staircase heading further down. Not a ladder this time, but an actual staircase.
Well, I'm not shouting. I'm trying to talk
loud
enough.
Whereabouts is she? Because I'm assuming it's one of these squares. Is it this one? Number one, level one?
Mm-hmm. Assuming level 1. So where am I? Where did I come down to? Here. Oh.
Here. Oh, here, there. Okay.
Well, there seems to be ladders coming down. Before you come down...
From where I am, can I even see her?
You cannot see. You can't see her, but well, you can make out where she's standing, and you know that she's only about 10 runs down. So you can kind of make her out, but you can't see amazing detail. It is dark down there, but the light coming in from the sky, you can make her out. You can make her out. It's only 10 foot. It's only 10 foot down. 10 steps down. That's all it is.
Yeah,
it's not like 100
feet. That was
down.
A jewelry box.
Yeah,
was only 10 foot
well,
down.
That was in water, and there was no roof on the tower, but. Yes, there. You can make her out. She's only 10 feet down. I mean, she's only 10 steps down, and Zellie's 6 feet high, so she's only about a meter below you.
Oh, okay.
I just say, like, there seems to be stairs coming down. Before you come down, mate, quickly make sure you've cleared out a fire thing and make it seem like we went there. You know, kind of just smudge it.
Made a stone ring. It took like 2 turns to move these.
Well,
I don't bother moving anything. I literally just get another, like, just lay it all out so it flattens out a bit more.
Yeah, you literally put your boot into the fire and start stomping it out.
Yeah, carefully though, not loud.
Oh no, you just stomp it out. It's not like no cracking or anything like that.
Like jumping on
yes, anything. You know fine well that there's 9 orcs sleeping in a tower less than 20 meters away.
No, idiots, they couldn't even smell. And then I start heading down.
I'm sure he wants a torch though, right?
I forgot the torch. I left it out there.
Oh, hi.
Hello.
Oh god. Okay, so
how dark is it in here? How dark is it across? Because Zellie has like super sight, so
yes, she can see. She's starting to switch over into the thermal visioning, and so you can see things like night vision.
What is the mood?
So it's like everything's all kind of a greeny, hazy, purpley, orange, like a hazy color.
Oh, I have to go into heat vision now.
Heat vision. If you see anything moving, which is living, it will give off a red aura in your vision, but other than that, everything else, all flat surfaces are all like dull blues and greys. Okay?
Yay, it's that dark.
It is very...
So it's pretty dark then.
Very dark.
I go back up to get my torch.
Oh, gold. God.
You didn't bring the torch?
You didn't tell me how dark it was, you just said it was dark. I thought there might be some light.
No!
You're completely underground. You're completely underground.
Look, my intelligence is not high, okay?
Wait, how high is your intelligence?
High enough to know better, but it didn't...
I thought you shared intelligence with me!
Oh, I think you're a little bit higher than me. I have 53 in value.
I have 53 in intelligence!
Oh, okay. I was just playing dumb then. I forgot it. That was all. I'll go back down now with it.
You're not that dumb.
Okay, so what are you doing? Well, are you back again?
I've got my torch, yeah. I've got my torch.
Okay, you've got your torch.
Well, I'm just going to stay here because I'm... Yeah.
I've had to add a little bit more tarp to it, though, because it was burnt through the tarp almost.
Yeah, okay. Okay, you have your torch. The torch is the only light source you have in this place.
Yes.
Awesome.
You get to the bottom of the staircase, and there's a corridor that runs left to right.
I kind of go slightly more ahead, so I'm kind of just outside his light, but still, like, pretty close to him.
Okay. Lee, you're casting beautiful shadows of Zellie on the floor.
Yep. You should really stay behind me, I think, if you want to do that, but then you'll cast a shadow behind me, so...
Yeah, that's why I want to go ahead, because I can at least see in the dark. You need to see in the light. That's why.
Yeah, but because the light's behind you, it's illuminating it.
Oh, making a shadow. Yeah, I see what you mean.
So she's telling me she's going to stay ahead of the light. So I go, okay, I'll hang back.
Well, what I was assuming
I'll wait for you to get
that
to the corner.
The people would see I would be able to get to wherever before your light hits that area. So, but stay like behind me. So I,
yeah.
At all times, so I know you're the
okay,
one that's behind me. You know?
Wait, you're the corridor goes left or right. Which way are you going?
We go to the...
Go to right. I guess the right.
I'm gonna eeny, meeny, miny, mo this.
Oh my god.
I don't know what rhymes there exist in Middle Earth, but I'm doing the equivalent to a meeny, miny, mo.
Okay.
Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. Catch a orc by its toe if you... Something.
If you know where I stabbed it, let me face it that way.
Meeny, meeny, miny, mo. I pick you. Let's go to the left.
Okay, you get to the bottom of the staircase.
I put my palm to my head and just go, oh my god, she's
Jesus.
A child.
And we got, you get to the bottom of the staircase. Zellie does her eeny, meeny, miny, mo and decide which direction to go in. There's no markings on the walls, there's no paintings, there's no signs, there's no runes, anything like that. It's just literally just flat stone. She goes to the left. As you go to the left, you notice that there's an alcove to the left again. Little alcove to the left.
Stairs going up? Stairs going down.
It's just a flat wall. You can just see a flat wall. It's just an alcove. And you continue further along the corridor. You're taking your time about it. You can't hear anything.
As we get to
the
alcove bit,
hmm?
Well, as Zeddy's Estelle's walk past the alcove, I want to look in the alcove.
It's a square stone alcove, flat stone alcove.
Is there any purpose for it to be there? Does it look like there's going to be like stuff hanging there? Or like?
Don't know.
Can I do a perception test?
Yep.
Like, have a look around on the floor, see if there's any marks.
I usually check behind me to make sure he's behind me. And his torch kind of wavered as I move ahead, so I'm just looking behind him like, what is he
what
doing?
What is your,
what are you doing?
Yeah, what are you doing?
I know.
What are you, how are you perceiving?
Yeah. What are you doing?
I'm looking around, see if there's anything around the room, like in this three corners. Just because it's a bit weird to have an empty jolt, unless there's something there.
We can check that after we check the room.
Okay. Well, you can check it out if you want to check it out.
After the room, it could be room.
Estelle's telling me after the room. We'll do it after the rooms then.
Okay,
right
after
now.
The rooms. Continue. Okay, after the rooms. Right, continue down the
you
corridor.
You want to check it now if you want to. I'm not saying.
No, it's fine. Let's go.
Okay.
Okay, you're going down into the room.
I'm this distance.
The room opens up to the right-hand side.
Mm-hmm.
I peer through the corner.
There
just
is
outside
a long shadow, like kind of a hallway. Yes?
I can't see anything in it.
Okay,
there is pictures of family portraits hanging up on the walls. And they seem to portray something like the original inhabitants of the castle.
Right.
They're
what
very
they
grimy,
like?
Very dusty, shrouded in cobwebs. The pictures of the castle, like painted oil paintings of the castle, and of its residents.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you're about here somewhere. And what they're doing is they're lining this wall down here. There's a long, long, wide room full of portraits of either the castle or of its inhabitants. Each of the portraits is very dusty, very old, dust-shrouded, grimy, and have no value at all.
Okay. Well, is that, you know, do we know they've got no value, or can we just say...
Well, you could, looking at them, you're probably thinking, yeah, you probably wouldn't give it space at home, but you can try and evaluate it if you wish to.
No, I don't know. I was just wondering how we assign value to something if we're looking at it, that was all.
Okay, it looks like it came out of a skip.
Okay, so it could be valuable to the right person then.
Yeah, to the right person, yes, maybe. To an art restorer
like maybe
or
a descendant
like that.
Or...
Yes, the frames are of solid oak. They're carved, they're very ornate, and to the right collector, probably a person with the right size picture, you might be able to sell one of the frames, the wooden frames. It's very heavy, for around about 5 gold pieces.
Right.
Okay.
I'm still just following
the Yeah, we keep going ahead until I see a door. Until I see some sort of door.
Okay, you keep going ahead. You're passing all these pictures and portraits and things like that of the castle. Oil paintings, pencil drawings, watercolours, all that sort of stuff. Each one of them has a lovely, beautiful, like, orc-carved frame. Each one of them 5 gold pieces in value. They're all dusty. They're all covered in cobwebs and dust and grime. And, well, and the frames have actually survived a lot better than what the original paintings have. You're halfway down this hallway. There is a door on the right-hand side wall.
Right.
Right.
The door's locked. Well, the door's not locked, but the door's closed.
But it's not locked.
We don't know it's locked.
I'm going to go close to the door. And I want Lee to stop. There. I do a hand.
Okay, so
a hand or hold.
You gesture for me to say hold.
Stop there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like hold for a sec. Yeah. And then I'm going to try the lock. Wait, I'm going to listen to the door first. I hold my hand on the lock and I'm listening through the door.
Okay. Door, do you have anything to
your
say?
Your hand on the door, you're listening to the... Were you listening to the door?
I'm listening to see if there's anything beyond the door.
You don't hear anything.
I try the door handle slowly.
There's a click, the latch lifts, and the door
I open it
open.
Slightly ajar.
The door
and peer through.
Creaks like it hasn't been opened in 400 or 500 years.
I just jar it open slightly and see what's inside.
Inside it you see a massive stone sarcophagus. It's a huge sarcophagus. It's approximately about 30 feet by 30 feet family mausoleum.
Is it like in the directly the middle sort of thing like there?
Yeah, it's sort
sarcophagus.
Of like directly in the middle here. Yes?
Right, okay. All right, so it is that entire square bit?
Yes, the entire square bit.
Okay.
Yes, it's a family mausoleum.
Family mausoleum. I am not searching this up. Oh, it's a... Okay.
Yeah? Family burial
you
chamber.
You were searching to find out what it was, weren't you?
I wanted to remind myself what a mausoleum was. Sorry.
Okay.
And I know what a mausoleum is now.
Right.
I've seen those before, okay.
Huge one, big one, massive. This is a really big.
So it's like a crypt of dead people.
That's right. That's why you couldn't hear anything.
The dead are asleep.
They're
dead tired.
I don't want to grave rob anytime soon, so I'm going to leave that room. I kind of whisper, it's basically a crypt of dead people.
Cool, I go in.
What the? What the? We're not robbing dead people, ew.
You killed people and robbed them, what the hell are you on about?
They're orcs, it's different.
Okay, this is...
And they were trying to kill us, it's all good.
Yeah, okay, this is the... You go into this mausoleum crypt...
What if they're
it's
ghosts?
Very the mausoleum crypt kind of thing is carved out of marble, and it has statues all the way around on each side of the people that are buried here.
I'm just gonna peer. I'm just gonna stay at this door and watch what he's doing.
Okay.
Seriously.
Okay. In the top of it is a kind of like a ring. Of carved into it, like a channel kind of carved into it, into a circle, and a small little depression in the middle.
Okay. So, possibly
On
maybe
top of the
something
crypt,
up
on top of
there.
the crypt, on top of the crypt, yes.
Yeah, so we could I how high up is that? Would I have
It's not
spotted
that
it?
high, it's probably about 5 feet.
How far?
You'd have to climb on top of the actual, like, one of the statues to get up on top.
Okay, I was thinking about maybe setting it alight, so maybe it's oil or something inside.
Oh.
I continue walking around.
Okay, you're walking. Yeah, you continue walking around. Zellie, what are you doing?
I go down here.
I'm just gonna stay at the door and kind of look out, but look in and watch what he's doing, because.
Okay, when he goes around the corner, you're gonna lose sight of him.
Really? Is that so? Is a wall?
Yeah, it's a solid block,
If
burial chamber
I'm
with for multiple people.
gonna lose sight of him, then I'll just walk like that until here. When he's going like that, and I lose sight of him, so I kind of hurry to here.
Right, so you're following Lee around the edges of this stone, giant stone family sarcophagus, mausoleum, family mausoleum. It's approximately about 5.5 feet high, and on each side of it, it's made of marble, and on each side of it, there's little like niches. Carvings of the people that used to live, of family members who used to live in this castle, are carved and stood there as statues, and you assume that the people. And you can read their names, and it says like
I was going to ask you, can I see what race they were, or what it looked like to us? What does it look like to me?
they are elven.
Okay, so this was an elven battleground.
Well, elven battleground. It's like an this fort was an elven stronghold once over.
Right.
It's a signal station for Rivendell. Remember, I kept on saying like every so far along the river, there's a
Yes.
ruin. There's a tower and a tower and a tower. This one, somebody actually lived in this one. Somebody, after that time, an astrologer took it over.
Okay.
And since that time, the astrologer no longer lives here, and now it's just been left to rack and ruin, and it's been taken care of by orcs, if you can call it being taken care of. But the mausoleum, the actual sarcophagus, the family tomb, has been here for a very, very long time. And that's why it's under the castle.
Yeah.
And you guys are now exploring it.
Is there anything round there that I think might be useful? Like, well, is there anything there that looks loose that I could pick up and look at? Any weapons that have been standing to one side? Any
There's no weapons.
candles?
There's no candles. It's just literally a marble solid sarcophagus with statues. The statues have been added afterwards, one by one. What they do is they carve the statue, then put it onto like a plinth.
Pedestal.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
As each person gets buried in one of the inside this tomb, a statue will be carved, and then it'll be placed on the plinth, and their name will be carved into the plinth, and then that's like another person, buried in the family tomb kind of thing.
Okay.
Zelly, what are you doing?
I'm just gonna keep an eye on him. As he's looking around, I
Okay.
can
I
kind
turn
of
around
look
to
around.
Estelle then.
Oh, does he see me, like, just keeping my eye on him?
Yeah.
Just following me around. Hello?
Okay, partway down that wall, you'll see a doorway. Nope, not quite there.
Is that one here, yeah?
Yes.
Okay,
This
so
one.
is this a notch in the wall, or is it going to be a
No,
flat?
that marks to me as a hidden door or a hidden panel. So
Okay, but there's nothing
this
there
is
for us.
completely
Literally,
flat.
it's just
Yes,
a
it's completely
complete
flat.
flat wall.
Yes, completely flat.
Okay.
Yes. So there's a door there. Yes.
Does it feel like the sense of the where we've stood? There should be a room here. From us walking up around the corner, does it feel
Yeah,
like there should be
it
something
feels
there?
as if there should be something there, because you know that this is fairly square. You came and walked around this corner, and this is kind of sticking out, so you're wondering. And
Yeah,
the
so
room goes like
this should be
this,
okay.
so you don't remember that being on the outside, so there could be something there, but likewise, it could also be that could just be completely sealed in.
So I say to Estelle, hey, look, there's a door here. Let's go and have a look. Can you hear anything on the other side?
On the door?
Yeah, down here.
Okay.
I is there like a keyhole or is there like a keyhole or anything like that?
Oh poop! I just
keyhole. No, it's just a normal regular door.
Okay, now I'm gonna now I'm gonna walk to the door.
You go to the door. There's a door there, Lee. You pointed out to Zellie. Zellie comes over and expects the door. It there's no actual locks to this place because let's face it, nobody really wants to be down here, and if they didn't realise it was underneath the stable, then nobody would actually be in here to begin with. So this door is open. Looking inside, you can see there is a bed. You think it's weird to have a bed in here? And there's also lots of smashed up crates. There's a couple of barrels. And there's lots of old clothing.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Well, Estelle's in the doorway, so can I ask her to move?
I'll just poke in, I'll be here then.
Yeah, poke in. Zellie, you can see there's clothes. I want to rummage through the... There's a lot of, like, sheets. A lot of pillowcases and things like that. There's a bed, and there is a couple of barrels.
What kind of pillowcases are they?
Just normal cotton pillowcases. Very dusty, very old.
What sort of clothes are they? Like armour sort of set? Or is it just general?
No, they just look like regular, everyday kind of...
Don't get them burned.
Clothing. Just regular clothing. It looks like everyday family clothing.
Okay. What, can I have a look in the barrels? Or is there anything on the barrels?
You look in the barrels and you can see that there is some lantern oil in the barrels.
Ooh.
And I can tell it's lantern oil. Can I, like...
Yes, you've seen lantern oil, you know what it is. Yes, it's lantern oil, yes. It has a very, petroleum spirit smell to lantern oil.
Now, from that reasoning, I'm assuming the thing around the top is lantern oil, so I go back into that room.
Okay, you're going back
into
the...
And I light it up. Yeah, I want to climb up to see if I can light up this.
To climb up, you'd have to climb on top of one of the statues.
Okay, I'll do that because I've got a...
You want me to have the torch then, yeah? Or you?
Yeah, while I'm climbing, if Estelle can hold the torch for me, I ask her.
Okay. Estelle's holding the torch.
So I saw the lantern oil too.
You saw the lantern oil. Yes, you saw the lantern oil. You come back into the corridor, Estelle. You've got the torch. You're on the bottom run. You are looking left and right, and you can see about 10 lovely carved elven people statues.
Mm-hmm.
And Lee standing on the shoulders of one of them.
Oh. Oh, is your climbing good?
Climbing's okay, it's
climbing's,
one.
Yeah, he's climbing.
I'm good. Plus 20 too.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
You want to know that story? Why do you want to do climbing up there if you want?
Well, look, I reckon there's lantern oil up here because there's a run up here. I reckon if you light this up, it'll be a flame to light the room up.
Then let me do the climbing. Unless you know how to climb.
Oh, it'd be fine.
Okay,
Lee, you climb up on top.
I can swim, I can climb, I can do everything.
Okay, Zellie, you're standing watching, holding the torch. You're standing watching Lee just, like, climb.
I'm just going to wait to see if he falls
shoulders.
Off.
And head of this elven
what happens
archer?
If he falls?
Well, then he hit the floor.
You catch me. Yeah, you catch me.
I'm not gonna catch you. I got a torch. Damn it.
No, Lee climbs onto the top, no problem. He kind of like rolls himself onto the top. It's only about 5 to 6 feet high.
5 foot. I was gonna say.
Okay.
I thought it would be more. Lee, you make your way over to the center, and although Zellie's got the torch, there is enough light in the room for you to put your fingers into what you. Is kind of like a groove that goes round in a circle.
Yeah.
And it has lantern oil in the groove.
Excellent. I go back to Estelle and ask her to have the torch back.
I'll hand him the torch.
Give him the torch.
Like,
and then I go back again. Yes. And I light that up.
You light it up. You light it up. It goes whoosh in one direction. It goes whoosh in the other direction. And this, it kind of got like a flame, like a firewall, a ring of fire.
Yeah, so that should help light the room up anyway.
And that's lit the room up on all, like, this square room. It hasn't lit up the whole place, but it's lit up this square room.
Yeah, yeah. That's okay. Cool, and we can see a bit more clearer now. Is there anything now that it's a little bit lighter I can see while I'm standing on top of this?
Really smooth, polished, solid piece of marble, the top.
Okay. No help at all. Okay, I climb. I pass the torch back to Estelle and I just jump down. And then I take it off her again.
You literally spring off the top of the... Pass the torch back to Zellie and spring down and land on the floor again.
And yes. Then you take the torch take it off.
Okay, this room somehow is now well brightly lit. The light, the orange light of the lantern of oil flame has been radiated off the actual white marble. And you can see all of the elven statues down at least two sides if you stand in the corner.
Yep.
But all of everybody that's been buried inside this mausoleum.
Is there a way to slowly take out some lantern oil from the caskets, the barrels?
Yeah, you have to.
Depends
take it
if
out.
You have some sort of container or something, don't you? You know, if you have a container, maybe you could take some out, but otherwise you'll be just tipping it on the floor.
That's why I wanted to see if I can tip into one of my empty bottles.
Well, I presume I opened the top of it, so you would just scoop a little bit.
You could tip it out, yes. They're not huge barrels. They're only probably quarter size barrels. They're not massive.
Okay.
You'd be able to pick a one up and tip it, yes.
So when eventually we could get a lantern, I thought I'd use that lantern oil.
Yes, it's just lantern oil.
I want to fill one of my empty bottles with lantern oil.
Okay. You...
I don't know how much that will be, but...
Enough to light probably about 6 torches or 1 lantern. Keep 1 lantern go for an hour.
Yeah, I'll fill 1 empty bottle.
Okay.
I'll ask her what she's doing and she'll explain that to me and I'll say, clever girl.
I'm just filling. I have a I just got some bottles, so I thought I'd fill one with lantern.
Where'd you get the bottles from?
Up on the third floor of that tower.
So there was nothing up there.
Because I got everything that was useful from there. I'm guessing the silent treatment just mean. Oh, the fire lady.
I was eating, sorry.
Oh, I thought you were actually RPing like,
I will,
being smart ass or something.
Back out. I just walk back out.
Okay.
As I walk out, I want to do a perception test to find out where the second door is because I realise there's a.
Okay, yes, it's an orchard room thing. Yes, yeah. We didn't find that on the inside. So, yes, let me just get back into perception. I'll just roll because I don't know what you're going to come up with. What's your perception?
My perception is. Where is it?
I'll find it. Your perception is 6.
Where? Oh, there it is. Okay.
I just pulled it, and I'm coming out.
Okay, you pulled it.
Yes, I have perception of 6.
6. You're percepting along this wall here. Yes. So roll. Go. Both dice. 6. Freaking big number.
Roll. Ready?
Go. It's a 9.
9. Excellent. I'm not rolling that way. Roll this way.
3.
93. Plus 6.
That's
99. Oh. 99! 99.
You know that there is something amiss here.
Mm-hmm.
There is something on the other side of this wall. But you're not sure what triggers it or what opens it yet. You can try again, but you can't try again right away.
No, that's fine.
But there is something, you know that it doesn't, this doesn't add up. There is something behind this wall, and this wall, you got to go along this wall, literally just tapping it with your forefinger, and you think, yeah, there's something here, but you're not sure where it is. You can try again, but you can try again in an hour.
Okay.
Okay?
Yes. I say to Estelle, there's something amiss, you know, there should be another room here somewhere. From the shape of the wall we came round... There should be something here.
No, one second, okay.
Okay, I don't say to Estelle. What I do is I look at this side of the wall, and can I count like steps to where the door is, and then go from that side and count the steps to see where the door should be if it's a mirror image?
Yes, you can do that, yes.
So I do that then.
You do that, yes, you count
that. And I have a rough guess, it should be around about here somewhere.
Yep, it's about 10 from that end and 10 from that end, so you work it out, yes, there is something. You can deduce just by that and the actual sound of the wall that there is something behind this wall somewhere. Yeah, there is something there, but you're not too sure what triggers it or what opens it.
Right, okay, so looking at the wall, it doesn't look like anything I push against, and you know, it looks like the wall will move away with some sort of action. Is that correct? Is that what I found out?
That's right, yes. You've looked at the wall, there's nothing that you can press, or no like buttons, or moving panels, or sliding stones, or anything like that.
Has the floor given me any idea of what it might do? Like,
nope.
Is there scrapes on the floor? Is there nothing like that?
There's no script marks on the floor. There's no as if a block slides in and out. No marks or anything like that.
That's all I can.
Okay.
Apparently, just...
As I remember, I tell her that there's something different about this panel on the wall. Like there's a door that should be here, but it's hidden. Or
okay.
I worked out it being here because I've counted 10
there.
Spaces.
There's something he's counted.
I guess it's like a little alcovey. Why would it be dipped like that?
Yeah.
For us, I don't think
he's
it
measured
be,
it. He's worked it. He's measured it out from the outside wall and from the steps in to the door. There's a door on one side, but there's no door on the other side. He's gone along the wall tapping, and he knows that there is something hollow in that vicinity.
Okay. So keep an eye open for any switches that might open this door.
But he's checked the wall for switches, he's checked the floor for switches, and he can't see any scratch marks or any floor panels, pressure pads.
Is it weak
pads.
To break through?
It's marble.
It's a stone wall, isn't it? Yeah.
Oh.
So no.
It's a completely flat piece of marble.
Why is it shut?
The way it was shut, and it was made by those
Maybe
who
did. It's a crypt that we shouldn't break into because it's dead people inside.
Maybe, but maybe there's also treasure in there that they've kept. You seem to be all one for random treasure at the moment. Could be treasure, could be items that we need. We've still got a fair trip to go yet.
There's
anything
a lot
we can
of
find that helps will help.
Yeah.
I start walking off down the road here.
down the road here.
Oh, you're dashing through.
Dashing.
Well, I guess we don't have a lot of time because when we need to go back up there. If those orcs are awake, they're going to find our dead mates.
Well, they're dead mates anyway.
They're dead mates.
Okay, so what are you doing, Zellie?
I'm trying to keep to his light somewhere. Where
this
his
room,
light is.
This room is well lit now because he's lit the
lantern
oil. Oh, yeah, I... Well, I saw where he went, so I'm following.
Okay.
I saw where he
You're
went.
You're following Lee. Lee, where are you going?
I want to go and just check, because I've walked around it, and I know there's two doors
walking
here.
Walking around the perimeter of the... And again, you're passing more statues of elven male warriors. Ahead of you is a door to the right, and then that goes along the kind of the north face of the sarcophagus, and there's a second door on the right at the far end.
I'm assuming you want me to check this door.
Yeah, can you hear anything, apart from the roaring fire that's around here?
I put my ear to the door. I put my ear to the door.
Okay, you don't hear anything, it seems?
You can't hear anything.
I try the door.
Then.
I try the door. If it opens.
You try the door opens.
I check inside.
Yeah, remember, he said hardly any of these are locked.
These aren't really locked. I mean, you have to remember, you found this under a stable. It was a storage room and a wine cellar, but it has been looted.
Ooh. Oh.
Ah.
It has been looted. The chamber is now useless, holding only the cobwebs and empty broken wine bottles all over the place.
Okay.
Anything that's not broken?
Which door she wants to go?
No, this is fairly wrecked room. It's a complete... It's just basically... There were shelves and they had wine bottles on them and they've all been either taken or they've all been broken.
I'm assuming from here I can see that this door was this door that we saw
that door,
earlier.
Yes, and there's a cupboard up against that door.
So we wouldn't be able to get in on that one.
Yeah. Clever.
Clever.
So there's two doors. There's one either side here. Which one do you want to go to?
Since we're closer to this one, I'm going to just check to see how it what this door, if it does that.
That door? Yeah, okay. it's another door. It faces, it goes back out onto the long corridor of paintings.
Why is that little circle in the map here?
That, when you open the door up, is a statue. It's a marble statue of a elf warrior.
But it kind of scares me because it seems to be there.
Yeah, it seems to be twice the size of the normal ones in the carved into the walls of the sarcophagus.
Hmm.
Oh. Okay.
It must be even more important.
I want to have a close look at that statue.
Close look at the statue?
Yeah, like, is there anything around it? Like, what's it holding on?
There's nothing on it. It's a marble statue. With the exception of he has a gold pendant.
So it's an actual item around his neck?
It's hanging around his neck, yes.
A what?
Still, look, he's wearing a necklace.
Hanging around his neck. The rest of it, all the other items that he has, is carved marble. So he's got a marble spear.
I'd rather we check what that is before taking it.
How do we check? What have you got that can check it?
Perceiving it.
Perceiving it, right, okay.
All I can do is look at it.
I can't do any more of that.
Really?
Yeah, well, I've done my one for the day. Well, for the hour.
How many power points you got?
You got 3 power points, you can do it!
Oh, I thought perceiving it, though, wasn't...
Not perceiving, actually doing a spell.
Oh, was it spell?
Essence. You got essence hand and essence wave.
At least to see if it's not, like to see if it's magically enchanted, or... Like, why is it round specifically the statue?
Hanging round the statue's neck, and it's a piece of gold. It's a gold necklace, a gold chain.
Or maybe it's like a switch, or looking at it.
That's what you can see when you just by looking at it. You can see it's just a gold chain. It's a heavy gold chain. It's hanging round his neck. Interlocking links. Everything else on the statue. He's got a marble spear. It is a marble elf, probably around about 8 feet high.
Yeah, okay. 8 feet, wow. As I say, I asked Estelle if she's got anything that can detect anything on it.
Okay.
Nope.
Okay, I will do Essence Ways then.
Essence Ways.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Yep, done that. I'm going to roll.
Roll the dice, yep.
line up.
That was bad.
How is that still a zero? Oh my god.
Eight.
Okay.
I'll admit that for me, nothing moved. Even though I clicked it ages ago.
You don't get any information from the spell whatsoever. It's just you don't get anything back from it. You can't tell if something's blocking it, or if it just didn't work, or you just there's just nothing there anyway. But there is just nothing.
A bad day.
Nothing from that spell. You can't pick up anything on the statue or on the necklace because it covers a 5-foot radius, doesn't it? So
yeah,
yes, you can't pick up anything in the proximity detecting essence.
Right.
Not saying that it didn't work. I'm not saying it didn't work or didn't. Not saying it did work, but you just don't get anything. You just cast a spell and go. I don't know.
Yeah, I cast it, but I think I cast it.
Okay.
Okay. How many times can I do that then?
Oh, you can do it until you run out of power points. That's the limit.
So I can try it again, can I?
Yeah, you can try again. Yes.
If you want.
I want to try again.
I guess you don't really have anything else in terms of spells, right?
Only the one that makes it vibrate.
I'm going to vibrate.
Yeah, but I can only vibrate small objects.
Yeah, small objects.
That makes it worse! If you're thinking what I just thought right now.
Oh,
that's so bad.
Okay.
Oh, dear.
So.
Should I do it again? Actually, no, I'm going to leave it. I'm feeling that it's too risky for me to do it now.
Zellie.
You're not going to do another spell.
No.
Well, if you think there's nothing to do with it, I guess take it, but
I want to pick it up and take it.
I'm just gonna stand right here.
I asked Estelle if she thinks it's a good idea. Considering it's in a crib.
Almost, just moving, you know, up the corridor the way.
Just
in case if it starts moving or if it does a trap thingy or anything, considering how old it is and no one's touched it.
Okay, oh, so you are staring at this, deciding what to do. The Lee kind of just went, the spell just like went, I don't know.
If you're saying there's nothing in it, then I'm guessing it's safe, just from our knowledge. Yeah. But statues are kind of freaky, so I really just want to stay.
Especially in a mausoleum, follow them.
Yeah, and dead people on the other side. So I'm just going to stay here.
What, do you think it might be cursed?
It could be anything. Could be cursed, could be a trap, could have a switch that will open things.
Okay, shush.
Could be actually just a gold necklace and we would be happy.
Let's go and check out the other room first and I will decide on the way.
Oh god, which room?
We've checked most of the rooms, haven't we? Oh wait, we haven't done this door. Go back here!
Okay, we'll head back through.
We're going to go through the other door. You've got to try the other door, yes?
Yeah. I'm going to leave that alone now.
I'm going
out this door.
Yeah.
Why would it have a gold necklace randomly? Unless he's like super important. Or a fake.
But it's the only other statue that's different from all the others as well.
That's why it freaks me out. I don't... Maybe I'm being overly paranoid.
Okay, you go into this corridor, and this appears to be a... Oh, hang on a bit.
It's a corridor. Right?
Oh. No, it's not a corridor. It's a long chamber. It's a long chamber. And up against one wall is all the weapons that belonged to the people now buried in the mausoleum.
Yeah.
Oh, nice. Yeah, so what?
All the weapons that belong to the people that are buried in the mausoleum.
So is it a closed off wall here then?
Hang on, where are we at? Yeah, because I'm reading this. What? All the way along this wall, there is weapon racks.
Okay.
With weapons on. Just like down here was all the pictures. Yeah.
Okay. So is that picture? I say to Estelle, do you reckon these are weapons and pictures of the people in the crib?
Yes, more or less. And then there's little statues. There's kind of little statues dotted all the way around the edges of what these people look like.
Yeah. Okay. I totally see that.
So, people that are buried in this tomb. Yes, these are portraits of them. These are little statues of them. And these are the belongings to them, mostly in the way of weapons. These were all elven warriors that have been buried in this family mausoleum. This was a wine cellar. That wine cellar has been completely wrecked off now.
Yeah.
And this was some kind of like a storage room. It had clothes in and it had a couple of lanterns. Barrels of lantern oil. But down here is stored all the weapons of the people that are buried in the mausoleum. Okay.
Cool. I'm having a field day now. I'm happy. Weapons. Can we see what type of weapons are there? They're like swords and axes and polearm and
there's
bones.
A rack full of broadswords. There is a rack full of javelins. There is a rack full of longbows. There is a rack full of battle axes.
Are they still serviceable?
They're all serviceable and they're all elven.
Yes, which means
they're
better.
And there is a rack full of Morningstars. Sorry, Morningstars.
Well, ooh. I don't want to...
Well, I still was thinking, I go and pick a broadsword up and look at it. I'm going to give it a good look. Feel the weight of it, you know, swing it around a little bit.
Okay, roll the dice.
Shit.
Oh, because you're swinging it around or because you picked up a weapon?
Because you picked up a weapon.
Ah!
Where's
it gone?
Oh, 50.
Oh, 5.
Okay. Oh, no.
Uh, Oh, you nipped it.
Fell on the floor.
I knocked the five off.
And it's now 84.
Eight. Yeah.
Okay.
Even better.
You, Lee, you pick up a broadsword.
Yay, I actually pick up what I mean to.
It is surprisingly sharp, and it turns out to be of fine construction.
Nice.
So I'm guessing he's going to take it
feels
as a
good,
weapon.
Like the weight and all that. Does it feel good for
it,
me?
It feels nicely counterbalanced. It looks like you can easily be able to actually slash and parry with this. Much better than the one you've currently got.
I want to take mine. I want to take that instead of mine.
Okay, so you're leaving yours behind?
Yes.
So he's putting...
I'll put my old one back there, and okay. I will take the new one.
Okay, you take the new one. So you replace your... You got a broadsword to begin with, yes?
I have, yep.
Yes. So you take your broadsword and swap it for a +5 broadsword.
Oh, yeah.
I look at any kind of... Anything that's like daggers or short swords or bows...
There's some longbows.
Just longbows?
Yes, just longbows. I'll tell you what there is. There is some broadswords, morning stars, javelins, longbows, and battle axes.
No short swords.
No short swords.
Ew. I'm going to go to the longbow
section. I will ask
Estelle
what she's after.
I'm going to the longbow section.
Okay, you see that there is that. A rack of around about... About 10 longbows. Not many, but about 10 longbows.
Can I ask, will the 8 arrows I have suit for the longbow, or would I need better?
You got short bow arrows, haven't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, they're not long enough to fit into a longbow. When you pull it back...
No.
Is there any arrows for longbows in there?
Yes, there is. There's arrows with them.
Is it in a quiver?
They're
in a quiver.
There's
a bow, like, stood up on its end, facing inwards, and hanging off the top of the bow is a quiver with several arrows in, on each of the bows.
How many arrows in size?
3.
I go up to Estelle, go on, take it. They're not going to need it now. They're dead. Do you better in your life than it will them. Them in the dust here.
Because I was hoping just to drop one of those off, but I want to save those short bow arrows as much as possible.
There's 3 arrows in a quiver. They are elven. How many quivers are there?
Yeah. There's
10
unless...
quivers. 10 bows, 10 quivers.
Unless I take one quiver with the 3 bows in it, and then take... arrows from the arrows. Other quivers.
Yeah, that's what he's saying.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. So I can drop my short bow.
You can drop the short bow if you want, yeah.
I'll drop the short bow.
And the short arrows.
And the short arrows.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't want to damage this paper.
Okay, no. Roll the dice, Sally.
Okay.
You pick up a bow and it triggers a trap and we all blow up.
Oh, shush.
Here we go.
Oh!
Yeah, Zellie.
Oh, so they all go when you.
I'm still dropping the short bow, right?
Yeah, you drop the short bow and you drop the short arrows. You pick up the bow. It is a regular bow. It's a regular elven bow. Yes?
Mm-hmm.
You pick up the quiver. And you pick up the 3 arrows.
Mm-hmm.
They don't serve any bonuses at all. They're just a normal elven longbow with 3 arrows. When you go to try and take the other arrows out of their quiver, or the other quivers, yes, they don't want to come out of the other quiver. They're like being... forcefully fixed into the quiver. They won't come out of the quiver. But you can take the arrows that you've already got in the quiver that you've already picked up. They come and go in very, very easily. But all the other ones seem to want to reside in their own individual quivers. So you have a long bow with 3 arrows.
Oh dear, oh dear.
No, I'm gonna keep that short bow.
Can I, while
And
she's
take
done
the
that,
long bow.
can I
What?
not get the arrows out as well? Can I try
No,
to
you can't
whittle
remove the
the
arrows.
arrow?
Yeah.
Is that they are totally stuck?
I'm
It's
keeping
not
my short bow.
yeah, they're all stuck. All the arrows refuse to leave the quiver.
Probably magically staying or something.
It's a binding, yeah.
Estelle tries to pull the bow back and goes, "No, it's too much work.
No, I don't, yeah.
I can't do this sort of thing in a dress."
Oh.
You playing with my sword? Yeah, got your sword, got your sword, yeah.
So, yes, so Zellie, you're keeping the elven longbow.
Yeah, I'm keeping both bows.
Oh, you're taking both bows now. Okay.
Yeah, I'm keeping both bows and the 8 arrows and the 3 arrows.
Okay.
So you're not
You
leaving
need to
anything to you there?
seriously work out where you're going to keep all this equipment.
Well, I keep the short bow kind of strapped to my backpack. And then the
And the
arrow
longbow.
quiver on that backpack as well, shoved in.
Oh,
Like,
God. And the longbow?
I keep that outside.
Okay. You have to carry
What
the
about your
longbow.
club? Where's your club
The
here?
club
Oh,
was on.
and your short sword, the one you got from the orc.
Strapped to.
You've got more weapons than I have. You've got to drop something. You're like a walking one-man band, just with rattling, you know, she's making more noise than I have been falling
Not to mention the
downstairs.
3 books that she picked up and.
She's like a walking junkyard.
Yeah?
I come over to her and go, "What the hell are you doing? You look like a walking junkyard." It's like, it's her kind of dragon. Don't, hello.
Yeah.
What have you got on you? What weapon have you got? I ask you.
A clock.
What cracky sword have you got there?
I can throw this sword away.
That's the oh, that's an sword, yeah.
Yeah, it's a crappy sword.
Yeah, throw that away. You don't need that.
Okay. I throw away the crappy sword.
Okay, get rid of the orc sword.
Yeah.
Right, get rid of that. Yeah.
Yeah.
God. Okay, so you got the orc short bow still, and you got a longbow, an elven longbow, with three
And I got
shots,
my club.
and your club, and you got three shots. You got three arrows.
Yep, and I got 8 arrows in the other one.
They're not pluses or anything like that. The orc bow is -5. The
Yeah.
elven bow is just a
Orc bow is
normal.
-5.
Yeah,
The short bow.
the orc short bow is -5.
Oh wow. Is it even
Yeah.
worth having that then?
I have plus t it's 20, so it doesn't matter.
But
The
then you've
missile weapons. In case. If it ends up the elven ones are those ones that run out,
a
if
short bow
it.
is a
Three
close range
shots.
one, remember? It's what, 20 feet we say, or 90 feet?
90.
90 feet.
Which is not far, really. It's not 90 meters. I mean,
If I
it's
end up
90
coming
feet is
up.
30
I
meters.
don't know. I would say
Probably
just.
from there.
If I can't
Yeah. I
recover
walk
the
away.
elven arrows, what's the point?
What if you can't recover these arrows, even though you're that close?
But I don't care about the 8 arrows. I
So you're going to use it up until you've used them, and then just like discard that crossbow.
Unless, like, I just have the short bow and try to strap the long bow on the thing and use the short bow first so I can throw it away when I used up all my arrows. Because it's crap anyway.
Might be good to get rid of something because you're going to be well overburdened soon. The amount of stuff
I'm
you keep
really
wanting to
close to
carry.
being overburdened at this rate. Most of it is in my backpack, though, and now
Yeah.
I'm like, yeah, it's going off a thing.
You said when we started this journey, I was getting way too much for the journey. I got what we needed. Look at you, you're like a
You
hoarder.
had a big, you had a caravan.
No, I'm talking about when we got to the barge. And we started getting like the
No, I didn't say we got too
carousel stuff.
much then.
Yeah, you
No,
did.
no.
Oh,
Wanted to buy good
okay.
food and all that.
You're in some ancient family mausoleum arguing about this.
Having a debate.
We're having a
Oh, but as
discussion.
we're doing this, I want to go back and have a look at the. Oh, I want to get the necklace.
question. I'll equip the short bow first.
Okay.
And leave the long bow for really importantness.
While Estelle's deciding that, can I walk back round to the... or can I go back over to the necklace?
I kind of go in that direction while I do that.
Can you go around back to the necklace? Yes, can you go around back to the necklace? Yes, you can.
I'm going much slower because I'm putting things.
You pass all the portraits. I'm a hoarder. All the old portraits of the castle and of the area as it once looked about 500 to 600 years ago, and of some of the people, the family that used to live in the castle above.
Can I see if the statue's face matches any of the ones that are in the picture?
It looks like a fairly square-jawed, plain-faced, elven male warrior.
Right, okay.
With a spear.
With a spear? Yes. So
it's a marble spear. The spear has been carved. It's a marble spear. And he has hanging round his neck a gold chain.
I turn to Estelle and I say, look, there's a room there. We know that's got a secret door. There's a switch somewhere. Do you think this necklace has anything to do with it?
That's why I said it could possibly be that, so you can try it. You can try it.
I want to do another essence wave detection on it.
Okay, roll.
Wait, yeah. Can I remind myself, was the poem sheet really recent?
Yes.
Was it recently written down?
Yes. No, not recently written, but like not within that. It was written probably about 100 years ago.
How long do you... was the crypt probably not opened for 100 years or so?
Quite possibly, yeah. It could have been sealed.
I got a 93.
That's... because now I'm thinking about this, because I have this poem here.
Oh, yeah. I'm just wondering if this... mention the poem.
Oh, yeah, I'm you know, when I asked her, did she find anything, she told me, no, just books and broken glass, so...
Well, I'm not... well, technically, yeah, it's like information in books and stuff. What was... I wasn't, like, lying or anything. I just said it in general. Because I didn't know if that was important for anything yet. So, I'm just wondering if this is referencing this.
I got a 93 anyway. And my base spell, is that what I need?
Yep. It's a 1. It's 2. Oh, 1.
Oh, you used another spell?
That's 94. Yeah. Okay. 94.
So that means minus 1?
No.
No, plus 1.
No, I mean to your... counter.
Yes,
so now it's one more spell left.
On that. Oh, Jesus Christ. Where
I'm coming towards while I just sorted that. I just finished sorting out my arrows.
Don't need that.
I do it better when you're not here.
Oh, am I destroying your concentration?
Whoa.
Yeah, half naked lady. It's like, oh. Well,
not half naked.
Soaking wet lady.
You know, there is 50. Oh my god.
I'm kind of dry by this point, I'm sure. Dryish.
What did you get? 94.
94
no armor. 94 no armor.
Why are you saying no armor? It's come alive! It stabs me through my chest and I die.
Right, it has to get less than 5.
A stone statue has to get less than 5.
What, less to come
than
alive?
5. Now I have to roll. You know, okay, you roll. You have to get less than 5. If you get less than 5, then you can find out what's happening.
No, you roll. You get less than 5 with bloody 2 dice. That's 45.
45. There is a ward on it.
See?
Okay.
I don't know what it is, but there is some kind of protection.
So
it seems to be connected with some sort of protection, but you don't know what it is, and you don't know what it does.
I can't identify it being protection of the item or protection of the person who wears it, or
That's right. You can't tell. You can't determine. You just know that it is some form of protection. But you don't know if it's like if it's a protection of the wearer, or protection of itself, or protection of the environment, or protection of other things.
Estelle, I sense there's it has some sort of detection on it. I don't know if it's of us or of the environment.
I thought
itself.
When you said protection, I thought you mean like it has a ward against us or something that we shouldn't touch it.
Like a protection on it. So it could be like a protection against fire, or it could be protection against
a necklace that is good for.
It could be that, or it could be it's associated with protection. So it's either protecting itself, it's protecting you or the wearer or the environment. Or it's got it's summit in somewhere. It's associated with protecting.
If I had some sort of spelly thing that does this kind of stuff, I would be able to. But I can't. I don't have any.
I look at Estelle and I'm going to turn around and say, "You better get ready to run."
with my things.
I then.
Maybe I can use my crappy short bow so I can run. Throw that away later.
I attempt to lift it off the statue.
Okay.
I got my shot bow ready.
Okay, you're very, very, like, you know, it's some kind of protection, so you don't know if it's protecting itself, so it could be electrocuted.
Yes, I'm being a bit wary on it.
Or you could send out a bolt or something like that, or it's some
That's
kind
why
of...
I was a wary of it in the beginning. I was like, this is the only statue here.
Well, there's True. Loads of them around the
Well, the only statue of that kind of...
There's a whole entire arm rack down here, though. So.
And considering how the bows, the quivers, they couldn't let me get the arrows out, that's why I'm like, this is elven really territory. They could put spells on things. Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah.
But why would an elf want to protect the statue?
Are you taking
the... I'm taking it. I'm taking it off. I'm taking it off slowly.
You lift it off.
I've got a short bow ready.
It's very heavy.
Oh.
Okay, it's very heavy, and it is of elven gold.
It doesn't do anything.
It's heavy.
We were paranoid for nothing.
Well, I don't know. It has a ward of protection on it.
So if you wear it, something will happen.
It might protect me.
Or it might kill
it might
you.
Do some, it okay. might do something else. It might protect itself, and do some damage to me. I'm putting it in my pocket and we're heading another direction for now.
Okay.
I'm not physically wearing it. I've got it.
That's fine. You put it in your pocket. It's heavy.
Infantry. What did you say it was? Elf gold.
It's elf gold. It's an elf gold chain.
Elf gold chain. Okay.
You can show it to the ward. River guys.
Hang on, okay. Put ward
oh, would they even like us robbing a crypt area?
I'm not going to tell them. I'm just saying I found it.
In one of your towers?
Just, you know, we just stole your swords. Don't worry. The dead people didn't need it.
Well, there's like a whole culture behind it, right? I feel dirty.
It protects me better than the dead. They would like me to hold on to it. I'm not doing anything evil. I'm not going out... Robin
We only traded in... Well, I didn't really trade much. Well, I traded the stupid...
Maybe leave a silver.
Leave a silver. They will do something with that money.
Hey, you know, you give two coins for the fairy master, so... When you die, well... In certain places. What did I say it was? Elf gold. Elf gold. Necklace. Ward.
I'm just thinking, like, should I just throw away anyway, even though it's eight more arrows I can use as ammo. I end up having only three arrows as ammo. But then I have a club.
Can I ask the description of the necklace? Is there like a lump on it, or is it a full gold necklace?
It's chains.
Okay, so there's no standing out bit or anything. It's
no,
just literally a chain.
It's just a gold chain.
Okay. Right, I'm drawing a little picture so I know.
Because maybe.
Okay, I'm good.
Hey, it's like 8 arrows for the 9 orcs that are sleeping upstairs.
Yeah, but you know what? I think they'll probably be waking soon.
Okay, what are you doing
exactly.
Now?
I'll have 8 bolts of crap to throw at
them. They do wake. I reckon we can ambush them down here, though. Mm. And block them in. Bang, bang.
Okay.
What do you want to do? Do you want to head back? You sorted? I've got my necklace now. I'm happy. Okay. As I'm walking down the corridor, is there any pictures that might have this necklace in it?
Oh, yeah.
I can keep an eye open for that.
No. Does he say this? You're looking at the first one, and then you look at the second one, and you get to the third one, and you hear a big crash behind you.
Ooh. I turn around. Is the statue falling apart?
The statue is now moving.
I knew it!
And is stepping off its plinth and getting into position to come after you.
Throw away! We're going! I knew this would happen! I had a sneaky suspicion. So I was correct.
So she's just moaning at me. I'm gonna... Okay, move!
I'm running.
How far down can we get before it's actually at us? Like, can we get to the door before it gets to us?
It's coming after you. It can't run. It is marble.
Mm-hmm.
It can only just walk.
But it can walk, but it has its spear in its hand.
Yeah.
I was pretty close to the corner anyway. I was further ahead. I was like,
I presume it's only going to go for me anyway, so.
I'm just going to stay here until I see Lee.
So, how far down before it throws the spear?
It's not throwing the spear. It's just literally walking at you, walking down after you.
Maybe it just wants its necklace back. Just give it back.
Do you think I should give it back? I don't know. I'm not saying anything
because, I'm just like, oh, Lee, I knew this would happen. I'm moaning that.
Yeah, okay, I've literally not moaned. I've not moved yet.
Oh, really? I just dashed here and you haven't moved.
I'm walking back slowly. Keep an eye on
it.
So as it's walking to
the end, Zellie, what are you doing?
Literally what I'm saying right now. What are you doing?
What are you...
Why are you going slow?
Wow, what happened there?
Okay.
Something has happened.
The stone monsters have come behind me.
Okay.
Anyway,
did you get scared by someone?
Because it's kind of supposed to be my quiet time. I just got scared by them. please cut this out.
We're leaving this in. That's great. That's great. Oh.
Okay. It's a stone golem. What it is the elves have the potential to cast wards.
I knew it.
Onto marble statues, and they act like guardians of tombs and places like this.
Yeah, remember we got to do our spell, so.
Yeah. Okay, the elves can create, they get the artists to create statues, the sculptors create statues, and then through a combination of elven magic and protection, they can unite objects with those them statues and turn them into what we call stone golems. And if anybody removes an item or interferes with an item or something like that, the guardian will come to life and pursue the people who have wronged or trespassed. So,
I knew it. See? What?
Is the guardian... Because he's walking towards me and I'm walking backwards. Has he done anything threatening yet?
No, he's just walking after you with his spear.
Is it wondering. Like in a point where it looks like it's gonna be attacking me, or is it looks like he's
he
just holding it?
Walking? He cannot. His spear was carved from marble, from the same marble as the marble
he
was created. So he can't throw it.
He can only prod you with it.
Okay, so I'm walking back still. Hopefully I've got a bit more speed than it.
Oh yeah, no, he is not running. He cannot sprint. Remember, he's a stone statue. He cannot.
Yes.
He has the he has the properties, the physical properties, and the physical maneuverability of marble. He's enchanted. He can move, but he cannot sprint. He cannot. He can see and he can hear. That is about the limitation. He cannot think for himself. He can't do magic, anything like that. His sole purpose is just to keep people out of this.
I'm guessing he's gonna follow wherever the necklace is.
He's just brought him to life, more or less, by interfering.
Well, I presume he won't be able to climb up the ladder.
He won't be able to climb up the ladder, no.
No.
We're presuming this.
He's like a marble stone statue. If we're coming up a wooden ladder, I presume that would just break it.
He won't be able.
And he's got one hand.
He can't sprint, he can't jump, he can't do acrobatics and silly things like that.
I might be able to get away with him.
He just patrols. But if he comes across anybody trespassing in his tomb, he will attack. Remember, he's made of marble, so he doesn't bleed, and he doesn't break any bones, and he doesn't sprain his ankle.
No.
There's no way to shatter it.
No. Let's keep moving. Keep moving.
Fine.
I keep saying to Estelle, just keep moving.
We never checked this alcove, did we?
No time.
This is why I said, like, don't give it to Bernie. I know what it's going to fuck.
Okay.
Yeah, I presume he must be at least. Oh, he was.
Where is he?
He must be about here by now.
Yeah, he's about here somewhere.
Get up the stairs.
Oh, shit. All right.
Okay.
Get up the stairs.
Okay. So, yeah, Zelie's going up there.
Up the stairs. You're up to the 10-point ladder.
I'm going. He's going up.
The
I'm climbing up.
I was
I'm not
in
look,
front
I'm
of
not
you,
looking
though.
Up. Yeah, I know. You're going up the ladder, aren't you? Yeah. So I'm going up. I'm not looking up, so don't worry.
Okay, you come out of the from in the stables, and Lee, you kick the trapdoor shut.
Don't kick it shut.
I don't want to kick it.
Oh, well, but you could. What if you do? You just close the trapdoor then.
I want to leave it open.
Okay.
Why?
Because if the orcs think we've gone down there, maybe they go down there. You know, and get killed. I'll close it, but I'll leave it so it's exposed.
Okay, yes.
Okay.
That's fine.
And then I say, let's go.
The stone golem will not pursue you. It is just there to protect the actual tomb, but it is now fully alert and fully active, so anybody else who comes along is just going to, like, you know, get rid
of deal with it. Yeah, so I'm hoping that all do go down there eventually.
Okay, but that means any other adventurers that come along now will automatically will, you know, have to deal with the golem. Now it doesn't go after the person actually took the chain. It's not that type.
It's just there to protect that area.
It just comes to life when somebody tries to interfere with things in that tomb.
That's fine.
Well done.
I can understand then. The necklace was to protect the tomb, so it would. Gives what?
See, you.
Can I identify it now? Being like it's an item that would give something a protective area then, or. Am I still not any advisor?
The protection you were getting the information from was from the actual statue rather than the chain.
Ah, right. So it's just a gold chain then?
It's just a plain gold chain.
I just hope that
I've got a chain.
The elves we soon will meet will recognise that.
Well, I've got one of their swords. You've got one of their bows. You've picked a load of money from them. You know, that's bound to have been the elf money as well.
Okay, there's still a slight problem of 9 orcs sleeping in this tower.
No problem. I'm going out.
We're leaving because...
I don't want to stick around any longer. I think I've overdone my welcome.
We've overstayed our welcome. Let's leave.
Okay.
I'm not particularly happy, but okay. Well, I was happy until that happened, but it's
I'm guessing from the look of Estelle's face, I can tell she's a bit moody. I'll chuck her an apple instead.
You chuck an apple at me?
Oh, yeah, so you can eat it.
Oh. But don't chuck it.
Well, you know, just not at you physically, just up in the air so you catch it. Towards you, you know.
Do I have to roll to see if I catch it?
I don't have to roll.
It's a simple catch.
Okay, you have left the ruins of that small castle kind of thing. After a...
What the hell?
...crazy bit of adventuring. But you didn't do too bad. You got yourself a couple of, semi-normal weapons. Nothing magical.
No. Well, I got a +5 sword.
Yeah, that's just because it's a little bit sharper and a little bit well-made. If it's a plus something like that, fine. It just means it's, more balanced and more adaptable towards you.
It's a bit of equipment, so that's fine.
Yeah, it's made from finer materials, that's all that means.
And then I just got any old bow.
Zellie got a load of silver pieces from the
from the chest. He'd buy a special weapon.
He doesn't know.
Plus a few extra bits.
No, well, I know you told me a few, because you said you had, a fair bit, and you were offering me at least 8.
Yeah, so
you
got a few silver
pieces. I was offering 9.
9, sorry.
No, and you only took 1.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. As well as some other bits and pieces that she came across and found. And you now know that then there is a tomb underneath this castle, and it might be worthwhile remembering that there could be possibly tombs underneath many castles.
Yes. Yeah. And we're not going to loot statues this time.
Oh, I don't know.
That's I'll the my... first and only statue you will loot from.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. We're eating our apples.
Okay.
I just give Zeddy the apple so she can shut up and eat it.
Shut up and eat it.
At least he had the sausage. So you've
had a sausage. Yeah. I had one sausage. Lee had 2.
Yeah.
But he's a big boy.
And you know that.
You're a big boy.
And you're also know now that ruins tend to also be the hangout places for orcs and other such villainous and vile creatures.
Yes.
So you've still got half a day's journey to get to Rivendell.
Mm-hmm.
We've done quite a lot in half a day.
Yes.
Considering that, I mean, it's probably the same length of time again.
Yes, pretty much, yes. Yeah. So you're basically cruising along the riverbank again.
Mm-hmm.
Join the regional path. Again, there doesn't seem to be anything around for a good... you don't see any people. Back in amongst all the tall grasses, the bulrushes, and all of the undergrowth, coming along this path again. The stream's getting a little bit more shallower. It's down to about 4 inches now in depth. There's fewer fish now, but it's getting much, much, much clearer. It's almost like perfectly clear water now. The water is... temperature is dropping to icy.
The temperature, so it's getting colder out, is it?
The water temperature.
Does it mean I see ice clumps forming?
You're not getting ice clumps forming. It just means that you're getting much, much, much more closer to the river source, which is the Misty Mountains.
Okay.
This is glacial water. And you continue your journey along the riverbank. After about 2 hours or so of just wandering along this riverbank, arguing about what you should have done and what you shouldn't have done, whether come after you, or whether the orcs will fall down that hole, or all that sort of stuff.
I got exhausted about an hour in. I just got exhausted for this. So I'm just eating my apple. I'm just eating my apple, because I'm...
How are you going to explain all this, and what are you going to do when you get to Rivendell? You pass another broken down tower.
Hey, look, there's another one.
On the opposite riverbank.
Is it the last one?
No, it's pretty much like the first one. It's just literally a pile of rubble. And again, it's got the occasional... It's not so much sheep this time, but it's got something like a wild boar or something like that, just like rooting around in amongst the rubble.
You can hunt a wild boar while you're at it.
What's wrong with you? You seem to give me a little cold shoulder.
Still continuing to follow the river.
I'm just walking behind her now because she seems to be grumpy with me.
Grumpy,
I'm not grumpy, I'm just...
You didn't even want to check over in the tower or anything like that?
Well, it's like the first one.
It's a ruined...
Found some blue moss at the first one.
You want to check it out, we can quickly, but considering how much... Even though we waste... We kind of... In a sense, we kind of wasted half the day.
That was your fault. You kept wanting to do it.
I wanted to waste my...
It's literally just a ruined tower. It's just... It's not even so much as moss on this one. It's just a pile of boulders and bricks and... Somebody's kind of rearranged it and turned it into some kind of pig pen.
Okay. I'll leave it and I'll continue on.
See?
Oh, God, what are you? You're already saying, like, you know, you wanted to check all the stuff out and...
I did, and then but I had bad feelings of the statue and you went and did it.
So, is Zeddy's going the wrong way now? She's started going the wrong way.
Sorry.
Okay, you are still following along the river. It's coming up to late afternoon.
Well, I suppose at this point we've actually come off the path, have we?
Yes, there's no path along the river. The river is now so shallow, you are following the riverbed.
Well, I originally said we are following the river now.
You're following the riverbed. The riverbed, it's down to just almost a trickle in the way it runs. It's about an inch to 2 inches deep in the deepest spots. You can see Rivendell. You can actually see the chimney pots and the house of Rivendell. It's only about 4 or 5 miles away now.
Oh, Rivendell. I say,
is that
east.
Where we're meant to be going? Yeah.
Yes,
there.
Rivendell.
Yeah,
yes.
We just keep following the river.
Keep following the river.
Just the river.
Just fling the thing. Okay, you're about a mile from Rivendell, and you hear a galloping horse.
Is it my horse? Is it my horse? Turn around. No.
What? Which? Where? From behind us or in front?
From behind you. From behind you, you hear a galloping horse.
Can we see from here?
Yes, you turn around, and you see Arwen on a grey horse with a smaller person she's holding on to. She runs through the river.
How did she... After all what we did for half a day, she was able to gallop all the way to who knows where and comes back.
Yes.
Well, you don't know how far she had to go, do you?
Maybe it was pretty close.
She comes galloping. She crosses over the river, turns around, and then out from behind the undergrowth and all the bushes comes... several dark riders.
Oh, what's that?
I guess we run.
you just literally just think, I'm not sticking around for this.
Turn this is
around,
a mound here.
Jump
yeah?
into the yes, jump in, jump into Can the I... embankment. Into the undergrowth kind of thing, and you watch from afar. You see Arwen turn around when she's on the far side of the river.
Where?
Draw a sword, just about here.
Oh, here?
Yeah. Draw a sword. And then she says something. The horse rears up on its hind legs. And you see, out of nowhere, a massive flood come racing down the river and wipes out the Nazgul. It wipes out the Nazgul, and the Nazgul get washed downstream.
Ah, Arik, yeah.
Hello, Dark Riders, no.
You're in the hiding behind the trees and hiding behind the bushes, and you see all this happening. She lowers the smaller person down to the ground, and kind of like once is checking to see if he's all right or checking to see if this person's all right, and starts shouting, "No, no, stay with me, stay with me."
Can I walk over there now and go? What the hell was that?
No. We're going to Rivendell.
This is no.
She's there.
We've got to
oh yeah.
There.
Never mind.
We've got to get to Rivendell. You're literally just half a kilometre away now.
Yeah, she's telling me we've got to get to Rivendell. I go, well, that was so cool! Did you see that flood of water? That was epic!
Yes, there was a massive flood. There was a huge flood that came down this way and wiped out the nine riders.
Where were we? We were here, right?
You're about there, yes. Yes, Rivendell is up here.
Oh, we have to go up.
Okay.
The
flood came down here, wiped out the nine riders. Arwen came back on the grey horse, bringing somebody else with her. She's now looking over that other person who's laid out on the riverbank shore, and she's shouting, "Stay with me, stay with me."
Okay, I won't go.
He's going.
I'm going to the little guy. Okay. Me. So yeah, I want to go over to her.
You go over to her?
I follow.
You follow. You hear more horses galloping, coming towards you, and these are white horses, white and brown horses.
Oh,
I want to jump back in the hedge.
Wait. I just want to double check. Is it coming this way?
Nope.
It's coming this way.
It's coming from they came from this way.
Wait, they're coming from that way?
Yeah.
Maybe they're from River.
Can Estelle sense, or not sense, can she hear the way they're coming from?
So the horses came down from here. Arwen came from this direction. This river flooded.
Yeah, I know.
And wiped out the Dark Riders.
Yeah. The Dark Riders were coming here.
Somewhere. They've just crossed over the river here. That's when they got wiped out. You're here, sort of thing. And
kind of meet
horses.
Up here.
So the whole thing's going down here.
Okay, so yeah, I say I didn't do it.
That's right, you turn around and you see six elven riders.
Yeah, yeah.
See, I knew around. They were elven riders.
But presumably, are they...
Because they're not dark. Like,
no, but like, are they pronounced weapons at us, or...?
No.
No.
They're just there looking at us, are they all...?
Yeah, it's an elven cavalry scout.
Okay, I'm just going to turn to them.
They've been sent out by Elrond to look for Arwen.
I'm going to turn to them and say, I'm with her. I'm like the only human here. I'm with her. And point to, I'm with these. You know, I'm going to point to Estelle and Elrond.
I think it's made clear. Yeah. Just don't
back on
talk.
She gets back onto the horse, pulls the other purse up. It says we must get to Elrond now.
Okay.
Oh, there's no way we go heading there.
One of the elven riders reaches down to Zellie with a hand. Mm. Yeah.
They're going to be very racist now, aren't they?
Zellie grabs hold of the hand and pulls Zellie up onto one of the horses. Another one reaches down and with a hand out to Lee.
Yay!
Yay, come on, we're going to get a ride to Rivendell.
Okay. Don't hurt me.
And you are given...
They're not going to hurt you.
So Arwen
and
six elven cavalry scout members are now racing towards Rivendell. It takes you a little under about 10 minutes to be able to get to Rivendell. Everybody's in such a frantic. Arwen goes immediately to see Elrond and you are left in the open courtyard area.
On the journey, though, can I ask... Like the rider I'm with, can I ask him? I'm presuming he's not even going to speak to me, but I'm going to ask him anyway. I'm going to ask him, so what's happened?
What's happened?
Yeah, what's happened?
He didn't know what's happened. He's just been told he was sent out on patrol and to find Arwen.
Is that all he's told me?
That's all you need to know.
Okay.
Yeah, it's like you. My business is my own.
I make sure I hide all the elven stuff I've got on me.
Oh, God. Right. Yes, no problem. You've been... They dismount. You dismount. You are left in an open courtyard outside the Great Hall of Rivendell. Arwen has gone straight to see her father, Elrond, and the riders have taken their horses to some elven stables. And that's where we will leave it. You have made it to Rivendell.
I have so much stuff.
You do. You're like a little order.
So the adventurers have made it
before,
to Rivendell.
Before we actually leave it, I want to ask Estelle if she thinks I'm going to meet my if she thinks I'm going to meet that Aragorn guy with the horse. Do you reckon he's here?
Don't know. Maybe.
And
I'll have to see.